gets ready to kick. Georgia Tech has won the coin toss, and they want their offense on the field first. This is Dez White, and White is brought down at the 25-yard line. And we'll get our first glimpse of Joe Hamilton from Alvin, South Carolina. Hamilton, number three in the country in total offense, leads the NCAA in pass efficiency. And he is the man on the spot. Many people believe that Ron Dayne has gained ground and possibly passed. Joe Hamilton would dispute that, and I got a feeling I would too. First and 10 at the 26. The Yellow Jackets in business on offense. Hamilton back to throw. To the flats it goes. It's Dez White up the sidelines, and he's knocked out of bounds by Alex Ardley. And let's take a look at our Geico starting lineups now as Dez White gets a 21-yard aerial from Joe Hamilton. And offensively, Sean Gregory take the third tailback. Dez White, Kelly Campbell, a great pass-catch combination.
Up front, they are stout. Keep your eye on Brett Key. Classic matchup against Terry Jolly.
First and 10, Georgia Tech at the 46-yard line. Hamilton brings them out. And the handoff goes to the fullback, Wilder, who's been fighting off injuries, gets over midfield to the 48 of Clemson. Let's take a look at the defensive starters. DeMont McKenzie's been fighting off an injury. Terry Jolly, Jason Holloman, and Terry Bryant, the front four.
Boy, is there any group better? This group gets to you. We talked a lot about Adams. Roderick Carson, equally as talented. In the secondary, they make plays all the way across the board, especially DeMarco Fox. Watch him hit.
Lead the ACC in interceptions at 17. Second down and 5 now for the Yellow Jackets at the 49. Here's Hamilton on the option, and Hamilton stretches the field down to the 45-yard line. Terry Jolly, the first man to hit him. Jolly out of Fort Valley, Georgia, junior, 6'2", 285.
See, there he is. That Jolly, I like him. I mean, he can really be a dominant factor for Clemson in this ballgame. Real quick off the hit. You know, he got a hit on Hamilton on the first play of the ballgame. So we're going to chart the hits on Joe Hamilton in passing situations.
Third down and 2. As Georgia Tech tries to keep this drive moving. Started at their own 26-yard line. They're at the Clemson 45. Out of the shotgun, here's Hamilton. Takes his own number, doesn't get very far. Guess who got him? Terry Jolly.
Hello.
I'm here.
Brett Key, again, we talked about that matchup. Boy, this guy, you know, you talk about kids who are 6'2", 285 pounds, not a sweat hog. He's athletic, so he gets off blocks well, and look at the passion. Man, this kid's fired up.
Intercepted a pass and returned it for a touchdown last week against Duke. Fourth down coming up. Dan Dyke is back to punt. And he gets off a good one. Calling for the fair catch is Carswell. And that's where Clemson will start, first and 10 at their own 8-yard line. A 43-yard punt. That was Zachary. Travis Zachary on the punt return. And he decided to fair catch inside the 10-yard line. So Brandon Streeter comes out and brings the offense with him. The fifth-year senior from Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Everybody thought that he was done when he broke his collarbone against North Carolina. He was not done. Came in relief of Woodrow Dantzler against Wake Forest and drove the Tigers to a 12-3 win. First and 10. Clemson at their own 8-yard line. And here's Zachary. Travis Zachary gets up about to the 10-yard line. Let's take a look at our Geico starting lineups here offensively. Travis Zachary, 141 yards a week ago. Two great receivers in Gardner and Wofford and Watts and Jason LeMay at the tight end.
A lot is mentioned about this group up front, undersized. Watch their footwork. They do a lot up front.
Brandon Streeter without a huddle. We'll talk about the ramifications there. Back to throw out of the shotgun. Guns it downfield. It is complete for Matt Lawyer at the 31-yard line. Let's look at the starting lineups defensively. Greg Gathers, a great two freshmen. Kreisen, Merrick Watson, and Felipe Claybrooks across the front.
And again, linebacker group that really gets to the ball well. Nick Rogers is a playmaker.
Got him.
And the secondary, Tillman and Clark, two guys we'll talk a little bit more about. I like Myers at the free safety spot in Young, and those guys do have a nose for the ball.
And we got a penalty on Clemson that'll call back this 20-yard gain. It's a procedure penalty. There's Robin Wood, our referee this afternoon from Lynchburg, Virginia.
illegal procedure on the offense. The substitute failed to come within the 9-yard markers after the ready for play.
Ouch. Tommy Bowden getting an explanation from the side judge, and he's not happy with what he heard. Instead of a 20-yard gain, it's going to be a 5-yard loss, and it brings up second down. Three wide receivers out. Travis Zachary in the backfield with Brandon Streeter. Streeter rolls right, fires to Lawyer. Lawyer standing out of bounds. He stepped out at the 6.5-yard line before he made his move upfield.
And that's one thing that the Clemson wideouts have to really caution themselves about. They get such wide splits, oftentimes outside of the numbers. So you got to know where you are. And you see he goes out right there. And see, and that's trouble. And that's one thing they just got to be conscious of.
Second down. Third down now and 11. Gain of maybe a yard on the pass. Four wide receivers, two aside. Streeter to gun. Streeter's pass nearly picked off. Knocked down by Jeremy Myers, the true freshman from Stone Mountain, Georgia, and also with help from Kerry Collins.
Georgia Tech needs to do this, and they need to do it a lot. Either make a play or put a Rydell in a rib cage area, because they've got to earn the respect of the Tiger wideouts.
Romano to punt it away out of the end zone. Gets a wobbler as he was kicking for his life. Here comes the return. Dez White. No, that's not White. That's Marvius Hester. Marvius Hester returns to the 32-yard line. It's a 37-yard punt. Let's take a look at Doc's analysis.
Well, some of it is already underway. Clark and Hester, the two wideouts. These guys have got to win on the edge. They got to deny yards after the catch, the big play, and, of course, run support. Then we get to Travis Zachary. Zachary's a guy's got to have success between the tackles. That'll put a lot of pressure on the outside guys. And then there's the Hamilton factor. What in the world you do with this guy, I don't know, other than gang tackle.
And they'll get a false start on this one, a flag down on the play here as Georgia Tech tries to take advantage of great field position after the short punt. Down to the Clemson 31-yard line.
First sideline warning on the defense.
Fans, the Domino's Bowl Blitz Sweepstakes entry deadline is tomorrow at 5 o'clock. So make sure you register online at jpsports.com for a chance at this football fan's dream trip. So having trouble getting the right people in the right game at the time they're supposed to, as Hamilton goes first and 10.
Oh boy, that's trouble.
Lots of room on the corner. Carson chasing, finally chased out of bounds by DeMarco Fox inside the 10 at the 5-yard line. A 20-yard gain for Joe Hamilton.
You can't give up contain. You know, it's very difficult to say how you stop him. Nobody has been able to do that. Fast flow defense. You see everybody, guys here going to this side, not even having the consciousness on him. The eyes are in here. He comes around. You can't have this kind of real estate. That puts you in big trouble.
Double wing. With Watkins and White. This is Watkins in motion. Hamilton to call his own number as the option broke down and he got inside the 10. Brought down on the play by Braxton Williams.
You got Braxton Williams, Carson. Talked a lot about Keith Adams. They get to the ball. They're so quick in pursuit. And with the triple option, you got to make sure you play responsibility defense. Don't fall for the okey-doke. Keep your vision on the guy with the ball.
Campbell is split wide out to the wide side of the field. Dez White to the short side on the top of the screen as Hamilton looks at second down and 9. And off goes to Gregory. Straight through. Nice gain to the 3-yard line. Pickup of 6 on the play. The tackle made by Robert Carswell.
Boy, good blocking up front. That Burks, as you see, that's what you want. You get a little crack for a good back. That was a nice big hole. Jason Burke up front, number 75, did an outstanding job.
Georgia Tech trying to take advantage of the aggressiveness of Clemson on defense. Third down, they can get a first inside the 1-yard line. They're at the 3. Wilder and Gregory are behind Hamilton on a long count. Hand off Gregory. Touchdown, Georgia Tech!
Hello, Steve-O. They took advantage of a penalty. They got field position, and they didn't mess around with it.
No, they
didn't. Big play by the Heisman candidate, and then they show you some toughness running between the tackles.
He made a lot of plays that drive. A 20-yard gain to the 10, and then Gregory carries the rest of the way from 3 yards out. Luke Van Jay with the point after. And Georgia Tech takes advantage of field possession as Gregory goes into the end zone and puts Georgia Tech up by a touchdown. Georgia Tech on the board first. It didn't take them long. As Doc said, it didn't waste any time. They got good field position, and a Clemson penalty helped the drive out of Georgia Tech.
That spurred it, and also a breakdown on containment against the Heisman candidate, Joe Hamilton. That you can't do.
Four plays, 31 yards, limited, 32 to execute. Gregory from 3 yards out, but a lot of it made by Joe Hamilton with a 20-yard gain. Van Jay with the kickoff. The 21-yard line. Hogg was the man who made the tackle. Paul Hogg, backup fullback, a 17-yard return. Let's go to the sidelines and Mike Hogwood.
The Clemson offense comes onto the field. You'll notice that the Tigers wearing all orange today. That's because Georgia Tech chose to wear white jerseys. Clemson wore all orange last week, senior day at home. The seniors asked Coach Bowden, hey, Coach, can we do it again? We got 58 points against Duke, all orange.
It must be the pants. First and 10, Clemson at their own 21-yard line. Brandon Streeter brings him out again. Three wide receivers to the short side of the field. Hand off to Zachary to the wide side of the field, and there's nothing there. Absolutely nothing there as the tackle is made by Ricardo Wimbush. Let's listen as Brian Wofford gets welcomed to the game. 'Turned and twisted at the torso.
That's physical.
Wow. Second down. And about 14 on the loss. Back to the 16-yard line. Play action. The pass to the tight end, LeMay, is incomplete. He was there. The ball was there. The hands weren't.
Clemson's got to find their rhythm. And that's the thing about it. When you run a hurry up, you put the defense on its heels, but you have to execute. If you don't, then it becomes detrimental to your cause.
We talked to Ralph Friedgen. We talked also to Ted Roof about the stress that no huddle puts on a defense. That'll start to show as this game wears down. Streeter now trying to get that rhythm. Puts it up in the air. Incomplete. Intended for Joe Don Reeves.
Myers, buddy. That's playing the defense. You know, you can be in a part of a zone combination coverage, but you got to get over there. If you got deep third, you have to make the move. Streeter telegraphed this, wasn't trying to hide it. And I'll tell you what, man, sometimes it helps to be lucky, too. Now let's watch on the backside, because sometimes you'll get a free runner. And in this case, might have been a chance. Might have been a chance.
Here's the punt by Ryan Romano. Again, kicking for his life back there. The kick taken by Hester. Hester, who averages 8 yards a return, almost broke one there, gets it to the 48-yard line, and again, Georgia Tech will open in Clemson territory. It's a 38-yard punt and a 6-yard return by Marvius Hester. So, Doc, early on, field position starts to be key for Georgia Tech.
Well, it does, and, you know, we favored Clemson defensively coming into this ball game, but, I mean, even a unit this talented needs some help.
You can't put Joe Hamilton in midfield.
No, man.
You got to get him at his end of the field. Four wide outs now for Georgia Tech. Hamilton back to throw the pass. It is incomplete for Dez White, and he was hit by Dextra Polite, senior from Moultrie, Georgia.
But lied about that. Breaking on the ball, man. That's what you want your corners to do. Drive through the rib cage to the football. The collision then can knock the ball out, and you send the message.
You have to defend so much against Georgia Tech. You got to be ready for the wideouts. You also have to keep in mind that they run the option better than anybody.
That's the worst part.
Yeah.
If you're Clemson on defense, how do you deal with the option and Joe Hamilton? That's what we reference as the Hamilton factor.
Second down. From the 48, 10 to go. Hand off. John Gregory scored the game's only touchdown to this point. No, it was Dez White out of the backfield. Dez White carries to the 45. You know, Ralph Friedgen talked about this yesterday. Likes to give White several different looks in the offense.
I would too. Anybody with that explosiveness. And again, Ralph Regent gives you his version of a lot of the things that Bowden likes to do. Ralph has it done in his own way, and he's been very successful.
Third down and seven. Georgia Tech, one out of two and third down conversions. Out of the shotgun, here's Hamilton. Clemson blitzing. There's the pass. It is complete to Watkins. Watkins with the first down and more. Brought down at the 34-yard line by Prolife. 13-yard gain for Kerry Watkins.
Oh, they're talking trash. I love it when they start talking trash. Now, let's watch Joe Hamilton on this one. Simple little flat right. Good hands. Turn up. Now you want to try to make people miss. And that's a good bit of running and good tackling on the part of Dexter Prolife.
Sal brings up another first down. And, you know, we thought, and another thing that Ralph Regent said yesterday, that with the attention paid to Campbell and White, that Watkins could have a big day. First and 10 at the 32. Hand off to Gregory. Gregory follows his fullback into the hole and falls ahead to the 28-yard line. Keith Adams making the tackle, a name we'll call doubtlessly a lot today.
Well, Adams is there and around, but I like what's going on up front for the Yellow Jackets. I mean, they gave you a little counter trade look on that one, pulling the guards and guarding. You just get traffic in there. I mean, they've really tried to be balanced.
Second down and six and a gain of four. Georgia Tech gives you so many looks. They've got a standard double tight end, two wide outs, and a lone setback.
Yeah, love the ace formation.
Hamilton checks off. Short drop. Goes the fade route to Campbell. Touchdown, Georgia Tech!
Awesome.
Nobody throws a fade better than Joe Hamilton.
Does it all. I mean, that's why he's a Heisman candidate. I mean, it's not hype. This is fact. Might have checked off at the line of scrimmage.
It was a long sequence, and Campbell makes the catch. For Campbell, it's his eighth touchdown reception of the year. The snap was a little low, but Luke Manjay picks it up out of the hold of George Godsey and kicks it through the upright. 7:14 left to go here in the first quarter of play. Georgia Tech on top, 14-0 over Clemson. Back. After these messages from your local ACC station. Only an engineer can put together a look like that. Georgia Tech 14, Clemson nothing. Joe Hamilton on a touchdown pass, the eighth of the year in the direction of Kelly Campbell.
Number 25, Brian Walford.
And the 20th touchdown pass of the year and the 56th of the career of Joe Hamilton, who is just three behind Jamie Barnett in the all-ACC touchdown pass category. Well, Wofford got his bell rung and torso twisted last time. Let's see what happens on Manjay's kick, and this one will come back. 9 yards deep, and it is going to be back at the 20-yard line. Next week, well, some of you will see from Chapel Hill, the North Carolina Tar Heels, reborn after their win over NC State. They're taking on the Duke Blue Devils. Coach Bill Dooley and I will be in Chapel Hill. Some of you will see that, or many of you will see the battle between Virginia and Maryland from College Park, as Mike Hogwood and Doc Walker bring you that game. Beginning at 12 noon, check your local listings for the game scene in your area. First and 10 at the 20 for Clemson. Brandon Streeter now wants to check off. Play clock down to 10. Down to 7. Gets the snap off in plenty of time. Zachary with the sweep. Zachary. And Clemson still in pursuit of positive yardage here on their third series of the day to the 21-yard line. Travaris Tillman comes up with a stop.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised at that. One of our keys with Zachary running between the tackles. I mean, I don't think you can get outside of Georgia Tech here at home as fired up as they are coming off a loss.
Second down and 8. Four wide receivers in the set down for the Tigers. Rolling right is Streeter. Streeter has a man. That's Watts.
Streeter's pass complete to number 6, Justin Watts.
Justin Watts, the junior from Florence, South Carolina, comes up with a reception. It's his 14th of the year.
and they needed this. Man, you just want to throw and catch. It doesn't have to be real complicated. Just move, try to move the chains, and Justin squares up and takes it north-south. Picks up some yards after the catch.
Look at the total yards. Now we got Woodrow Dantzler in the ball game at quarterback. Woody Dantzler carries. He's the real running threat and gets up over the 40-yard line to the 44. It's a gain of close to 12, and it's the second first down for the Clemson Tigers this afternoon, both of them coming on this drive. Here's Woodrow Dantzler, second leading rusher for the Clemson Tigers this season after taking over for Brandon Streeter during the North Carolina game. But Streeter's back out there again, and Tommy Bowden has decided that he's going to make Georgia Tech guess on every play.
Yeah, you better. If you have that kind of talent, utilize it.
Four wide receivers out for Brandon Streeter. Hand off to Zachary between the tackles into Georgia Tech territory, and he's close to a first down.
Now you're talking. Yeah, buddy, now you're talking. That's what you got to establish. Y 61 right there, left of your screen. See, that's the mess you want. That's a nice block there. And then you want to get those shoulders square and let Zachary go north-south. Y Smith with a rumble block.
You know, we were talking with Tommy Bowden on the field before the game, and he was talking about the field, the chain crew.
Yeah.
And he says, I want a fast chain crew to match what my offense does.
That's right.
Does.
I've never thought of that.
He says, I don't want any slow guys on the sidelines. They move the chains, and we get going.
Well, he thought the crew he had in Maryland really hurt his offense.
They won that game.
Yeah, that was the strange part about it.
Second down and inches. Streeter at the helm. Got four wide receivers out there for effect. Streeter will take it on his own and easy to get the first down across the 45-yard line. Looking at our Cross Creek scoreboard, Tech leading here 14-0. What's going on in the Big Ten? Well, Michigan, field goal over Penn State. They're in shock after their loss a week ago. And same old thing for Ohio State. They start behind and they wind up winning. Indiana trying to put a hurt on Minnesota. First and 10. Hand off Zachary. And Zachary straight ahead of the 40-yard line. He'll pick up four. Merrick Watson is there for the tackle for Georgia Tech. George O'Leary was a defensive coordinator under Bobby Ross when he was here. Went briefly to the pros with Ross to San Diego and came back here. He was named ACC Coach of the Year last year for his performance. Second down and 6. 5 wide receivers out. Flat pass to Walker. Complete at the 40.
Fumble that ball.
Fumble the ball, but looks like he's going to be able to maintain possession. Wofford, who's had some anxious moments today, pick up a 3. He almost treat that like a running play.
Well, they have so much of the wide receivers. Clemson's guys on the edge, they have to block. And this time, both guys, you had an 0 for 2, and the back, and the receiver rather has no shot.
Oh, that ball came right back to the stomach of Brian Wofford. Third down. Clemson down by 2 touchdowns, and they're going to be short a first down here. Wofford tackled immediately. Brought down by Jeremy Myers, and Streeter was hit on the play.
Boy, you hope it's not that shoulder again, but it sure... Oh, that doesn't look good. I hate that.
Brandon Streeter has been through his share.
Number 14, Brandon Streeter.
Tommy Bowden with concern on the other sideline. He's got a capable backup, more than capable in Woodrow Dantzler.
Yeah, but you want this kid healthy. You want all the kids healthy. You know, he worked his rear end off to get back. He's playing well. But, you know, you love this. It's a contact game. And, boy, the Jackets, they're bringing it. That's what you want to do. Force the issue.
Against North Carolina, this is the injury that put Brandon Streeter out, supposedly for the season. You can tell he knows something's wrong with that shoulder. He played a couple of plays before he went out. Broken collarbone. Woodrow Dantzler came in. Clemson just kept on winning. And then Streeter would come back against Wake Forest in the fourth quarter and lead 2 scoring drives that would carry the Tigers to the win.
In our games, and we've had Clemson, it's just been so obvious how they have dictated tempo, pace, everything. Well, the Yellow Jackets, blitzing. They've changed that. I mean, they've had some field position working in their advantage, but they've been so aggressive on the defensive end. I mean, Ted Roof and these boys, they got it going on.
And, you know, the thing about it is that by switching quarterbacks, as you look at Ted Roof, by switching quarterbacks, I thought Tommy Bowden was able to get more of that rhythm
back. I did, too.
We've got a timeout on the field with 4:12 left to go on the first. As we look at Brandon Streeter, we'll be right back.
New electronic e-tickets. These tickets make it easier for you.
Georgia Tech leading Clemson 14-0, but a bad stroke of luck for the Tigers, as that's Brandon Streeter taking in a lot of pain off the field with a stretcher, and it possibly is the right knee. Clemson now with their punter on the field. Romano will try to pin Georgia Tech in deep, and the Tigers field the kick at the 4-yard line and get the job done. Perfect punt, 36 yards, no return. Let's look at the injury again. It's the knee, it looks like.
Yeah, he also holding the left shoulder. You see him get hit, he goes down. Something to do with the shoulder, knee, what a collision. That's a lot.
Let's go to the sidelines and Mike Hogwood.
Well, the trainers actually think it's a dislocated hip. It is very, very painful.
A lot of pain as he went off the field. First and 10, Georgia Tech in the worst field position of the day from their own 5-yard line. Hamilton hands off to Gregory. And Gregory dives into the hole. Gets out to about the 9-yard line. A gain of 3 on the play. Robert Carswell comes in and makes the tackle. Gregory, the third running back for Georgia Tech this year. Joe Burns, Philip Rogers out with injuries. But Georgia Tech just rolls on, and it's the Hamilton factor.
Yeah, helps a lot when you have that guy under center.
2nd and 7. Joe to throw, the pass complete to Des White. Man. At the 26-yard line, it's a gain of 15.
Rifleman. When you talk about this kid and his stature and 5'10", 189, but watch the results. Now, this is from his vantage point. Now, he just throws through the lanes. I mean, that's a sizzler. Ball right on the numbers.
Mark at a 17-yard gain, 1st and 10, and there's Joe's total on the day. So 98 yards of total offense so far. Hamilton to throw again. Hamilton to the flats. It is complete. And this time, looks like that is Watkins.
Carey. Oh, Carey getting in. Now a little flavor going on. Two nines clashing.
14 yards on the carry.
Now watch the sidelines. Joe Hamilton, crafty. Understands the throwing lanes, the seams, if you will. Gets it right there. You know, and he gets it there on time. It gives his guy a chance to run after the catch.
Watkins with his 2nd catch of the day. 1st and 10. Georgia Tech, double tight end set. That's what Doc refers to as the ace formation.
Love that, man. The old skins look.
Hamilton checking off. It was out of this formation. He threw his touchdown pass. This one's complete to White, and a nice open field tackle made by Alex Arnwood, sophomore out of Tallahassee, Florida.
Back in Joe Gibbs' era in the 80s for the Washington Redskins, that would have been eighth formation, Charlie 10 Hitch. And they made Joe Theismann and the boy all have made a living out of it. They stretch you out, you get the one-on-one coverage. He can pick a side. I think he audibled on the fade route. Touchdown. I think he audibled on it.
Pass to the side that the safety wasn't present. It's the 3rd reception by White. 43 yards, 6 on that play. 2nd down and about 4. And off straight ahead to Sean Gregory. Tough yards up to the 48-yard line. Gain of about 3 on the play. We'll bring up 3rd down, and he'll be shy of the first.
Guess what they're working on now? Clock.
Yep.
See, now they can hog the ball, keep that offense over on the side, and they know that psychologically now, Clemson's got to be worried about their quarterback.
Yeah.
The kids you hurt when you see a teammate card it off.
And Tommy Bowden's going to wonder what kind of rhythm he can establish not being able to alternate quarterbacks, which seems to work. In that last drive, 3rd down, Tech up by 2 scores. Here's the pass, it is complete to Watkins. In Clemson territory at the 47 for the 1st down. A gain of about 5, and it's good enough to keep this drive moving.
You know, we talked about Terry Jolly in the open. Terry had a few big plays. Big John Carman, that right tackle right there, mountain of a man. I mean, he gives you those throwing lanes, and he's good with his feet too. Big fella, 300 and a lot. I'm not even a lot, but he's 6'8", and he's having a whale of a season.
And Hamilton's having a nice day, too. 7 out of 8, 102 yards and a score. There's movement early as Hamilton goes straight ahead, and sensing that there's an offside possibility, he gets the snap from center to try to catch Clemson in the neutral zone.
Here's a tough question for you, Steve Martin. Where's his flaw?
Offside. You know?
On the defense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
I don't know if there is one.
Throws the deep one, throws the intermediate, calls the game, runs the option,
there's
reads.
Reggie. When the week began, Reggie had hair. Pulled it all out trying to solve this.
Oh, Reggie.
He said, we're working on the eyebrows this week. I don't have any hair to pull out.
We like a Reg, man. He's into it.
Here's Hamilton throwing deep. Has Campbell open. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. There is a flag back at the 46.
Roughing on the quarterback. Yeah, he got drilled after the throw. I mean, and this shows you his toughness. I mean, speed kills. Al Davis and the Raiders made that famous in the 60s. It still holds true. Man, this kid is awesome. And Des White is the go-to guy. That's the sick part about this.
And this guy's got 20 more receptions this season. At first, he was a decoy.
Touchdown.
So Robin Wood confirms what Doc just said. So the try goes from the 3-yard line, half the distance to the goal line. And Manjay is in to kick it, his third kick of the day. At 42. He's been busy this season. This is an offense that scores early and often, and they've got 20 points rung on the board here in the first quarter. Make it 21. Kelly Campbell, his second touchdown reception of the day, the 57th career touchdown pass by Joe Hamilton. Well, he covers 42.
You know, Steve, let's give play action some credit. You know, because you can run the ball and because Clemson is so aggressive, I think it was a great call on that. Now, let's watch Joey Hamilton. He sets up. Watch the release. Oh, this is blatant.
Yeah.
And it wasn't a real physical hit. Let's give Keith some credit. Keith did back off at the end.
Reggie Herring pleading for some sort of authority to stop that particular play. Keith Adams made the mistake. Yeah. There's the scoring drive. 7 plays, 94 yards. They came from their own 6-yard line. Campbell with a 42-yard touchdown reception from that man, Joe Hamilton.
Yeah, but he got him. I think he got him right in the rib cage because Joe was holding his ribs as he came off. And Keith actually held off at the end. Could have finished through it.
Yeah. Good thing he did. 1:18 left to go here in the first quarter. Georgia Tech with 3 scoring drives, 2 touchdown passes from Joe Hamilton, the other a Sean Gregory run of 3 yards. Field position was the key in the first 2 scores, but just the finesse and the arm of Joe Hamilton and the speed of Kelly Campbell converted in a 3rd touchdown.
And that's why touching is something, coaching is such a tough thing to do, man, week in and week out.
Wofford from the 7. Wofford shields the ball and gets to the 20.
Number 25.
On the tackle, it's going to be Corey Collins. Led the charge after the kickoff, and Woodrow Dantzler's got a job for the rest of the afternoon.
Bet you Paul Hogg was somewhere around that ball, too. Number 49 for the Yellow Jackets is a nut on special teams.
Georgia Tech already has rolled up 192 total yards on offense. Clemson with 40 as Woodrow Dantzler is on. Dantzler, who rolled up 450 yards against Maryland, carries on the first play after play action in the opposite direction to the 24-yard line. Brought down on the play by Brian Korn. Here's Dantzler on the season. Unique that Clemson has never had a reputation as a passing school. Right. They had 2 players rack up 1,000 yards this year. Streeter and Dantzler.
And they love Willie Simmons. A freshman recruit out of Florida.
Second down and 6. Here's Dantzler's got the first down and more as he hits the corner and comes out to the 39-yard line. People have been able to move the football on Georgia Tech this year, and Dantzler proves that Clemson can do it.
And I think this is what happened to Maryland as well. You know, you prepare for one quarterback, the 2 different styles. All of a sudden, Dantzler gets in the game, and it's this element. to just catch and go that is very difficult to defend.
Final half minute of the first quarter. Georgia Tech up by three scores. Dantzler to carry again. Dantzler follows the block and gets out to the 45-yard line. Six hard yards. And the clock rolls down with 20 seconds left in the quarter. Brought down by Ross Mitchell.
He was tackled by number 26, Travaris Tillman.
Heck of an athlete. Clearly their best running back.
Yeah.
I mean, without question. I mean, maybe their best player.
He's listed as second best in rushing, but he didn't play three games. Second down. Handoff now to Zachary, who's the leading rusher for the Tigers. And Zachary busts to the outside. Jeremy Myers drives him out of the 30-yard line, but it's a gain of 15, actually 25 on the play.
And where to start?
He was forced out of bounds.
Between the tackles.
Exactly. And that's the end of the first quarter. It's been all Georgia Tech, but Clemson's mounting a march as we take the turn into the second here in Atlanta. Georgia Tech up 21-0. Welcome back to Bobby Dodd Stadium, historic Grant Field in Atlanta, Georgia, the oldest Division I venue. But it's been freshened up over the years, and it's hosting a good one. An offensive show this afternoon, so much for Georgia Tech, but Clemson is proving that they can move the football as well behind Woodrow Dantzler. Play action, pass is complete to Sergalis, the tight end, and Sergalis takes it all the way down to the 12-yard line. A gain of 17 on the play, and Clemson moving the football.
Yeah, and they need to get Pat back involved in the offense. Has been kind of idle, boy, has nice hands, is a running back, a fullback of nature. Now watch that, that's a good grab, kept his balance, and now he's rumbling.
Scored the first touchdown by a tight end in 10 years. He caught a pass against Virginia. Dantzler, flag thrown on the play, as Dantzler moves ahead of the 12-yard line. Let's take a look at our KFC first quarter stats. Merrick Watson was down on the field. And we'll wait to see what the flag is. Now let's go to the first quarter stats. The time of possession, 8:13. They've had three scoring drives, and the longest was 2 minutes and 33 seconds. And look at the passing yards.
Yeah. That's been all Tech.
This penalty is going to be marched off against Clemson. You heard the call, and that goes back to the 17-yard line. 5-yard penalty. No huddle for Clemson. The plays are signaled to the quarterback from the sideline. He has four wide receivers in the set. First down and 15. The fake, the pass, complete, touchdown. The tight end does it again. Pat Sergalis for the second time this season. They caught Tech in a blitz and made them pay.
Well, the notion that you're going to shut them out, I mean, that's absurd. They're going to find a way to get after you. It's just a matter of getting it going their way.
Pat Sergalis, the redshirt freshman from Kearney, New Jersey, scores for the Tigers, and Clemson's on the board. Here's Tony Lazzaro with the point after. The kick is up, and it is good. The tight end strikes as Dantzler takes advantage of the blitz and lofts it to Pat Sergalis from 17 yards out. Woody Dantzler throws the touchdown pass. It's his sixth of the season, hitting the tight end, Pat Sergalis. Only the second touchdown by a tight end in 10 years. There's Brandon Streeter. Likely his season and career at Clemson have come to a close on a dislocated hip. A very painful injury suffered in the first quarter. Here's the kickoff return. Dez White can electrify. And how he held on to the ball, Doc, I don't know. Out to the 27-yard line, a return of 25. And let's go to the sidelines to Mike Hogwood for an injury update on Joe Hamilton.
In the last series, you showed him with a vicious hit when he made that touchdown pass. He has very sore ribs. They have tightened that flat jacket around him. But Joe Hamilton has some sore ribs that he's going to have to live with for the rest of this game.
Hamilton has lived with a lot through his career. Trying to put a glorious finish to it in the next three games, this one included. First and 10 from the 26. Pass is complete to Gregory. Hides behind his backers and has an open field. One man to beat, that's Ardley. But look at Dexter Polite come from behind. Nonetheless, Sean Gregory. Catch and run down to the 16-yard line of Clemson.
LeSean should scoop. I mean, he's had a long run of 48 yards this season, but that's a little bit of poor tackling. I mean, this is unlike the Clemson Tigers. I mean, these guys, they had people in the area. I mean, you don't lose flank. That's just a missed tackle there. And then the gate's wide open. And you talk about Dexter Polite. Now, that shows you how quick Kelly Campbell is, because Dexter can run.
First and 10. Ball at the 16-yard line of Clemson. Handoff goes to Wilder. The fullback charges ahead to the 12-yard line. Let's take a look at what Joe Hamilton felt after that play.
It's like that little Jordan look with Michael Mays. You know, he lights it out, I think, two seasons ago. He just put those hands up.
He's managing the field. Gain of 3, second down and 7. Ball at the 12-yard line. And Georgia Tech is knocking on the door again. They lead it 21-7. There's Hamilton on the day. A bad start. We haven't even scraped the surface of the quarter. There's the pass. It is complete to the tight end. Into the end zone for a touchdown. That's Conrad Andrzejewski. His first touchdown of the year for the fifth-year senior from Wellington, New Jersey.
And he's happy. You know he's thrilled, too. He had a little clutch on that ball. He would have made sure he was able to suck it in. He did it. And the play action, really both sides have had some success with it. The magician, Joe Hamilton.
Hamilton, 3 touchdowns today. And he is one away from tying the all-ACC touchdown mark set a week ago by Jamie Barnett of North Carolina State. Luke Manger knocks in his 4th extra point of the afternoon. And we'll see it again. The tight ends have been included.
Well, that's play action. It's a byproduct of play action. Nice grab. And you get the score.
Andrzejewski, his first of the year. He's from Wellington, Florida.
Bad ribs and all.
Didn't get the extension on that arm.
No, he couldn't. The ribs, he's in some pain, as Mike Hogwood mentioned. He is in some pain. What a player.
Bank of America, an official corporate partner of the ACC, presents this Salute to Excellence question. Which ACC school became the league's first to win at least 7 football games 12 years in a row? If you know the answer, log on to theacc.com with the correct answer before next Saturday's telecast. You'll be entered to win 2 tickets to the ACC Champions Bowl game. Stay tuned. We'll have that answer for you before the end of the game. Theacc.com. Anything else gets you to some company you won't recognize. Trust me. Andrzejewski's 12-yard catch, the 3rd play of a 71-yard march, and it took them only 116. Joe Hamilton has only missed on 1 pass today. 213 yards and 3 touchdowns. And don't forget, he's rushed for 20 yards, and he's just getting hot.
Would you consider those Heisman-like numbers?
Very much so.
I thought you would.
He has another passing mark with Sean Jones in sight before the end of the season. Here comes the kick by Manjay, and this one will not come out either. Joe Don Reams decides to down it in the end zone. And Clemson will take over again, down 28-7 at the 20-yard line. And here's the race that Joe Hamilton now has vaulted himself from 5th when he started the day down there with Ben Bennett and Sean Moore to just 1 touchdown behind Jamie Barnett at 58 on the season and 1 ahead of Danny Cannell, the former Florida State star. First and 10 from the 20-yard line. Dantzler out of the shotgun. Hand off to Remper. That is Bernard Rambert, true freshman. Corey Collins in on the tackle. He's from Somerville, South Carolina. And there is Collins down on the play. Injuries have bedeviled Georgia Tech this season to the point where they've exposed 3 true freshmen in the starting lineup. This is one of them. He's an extra defensive back. And this is part of the big nickel package that Georgia Tech is forced to play because of the fact that Clemson doesn't come out there with a huddle.
Yeah, you don't want to lose any of the kids, but, you know, especially in your secondary. A play like this usually results to a knee to the helmet. Yeah. Oh, man.
Bell rung.
Had that happen.
We've had some hard hits today. Already lost Brandon Streeter with a dislocated hip. Want to remind you to stay tuned at halftime for our Bell South You Call the Play feature, a look at a big call from ACC games past, and the crowd comes to a hush here as Corey Collins is checked over on the field. There aren't many more options for George O'Leary, looking at true freshmen coming in to play what ostensibly is a nickel package, and now he comes off the field by his own power. Now, in ACC history, total offense, teams to average over 500. You know Florida State's going to be up there. Look at what Georgia Tech is putting up. And, of course, today they're already halfway to the 500 mark and probably well over that. So that margin will keep intact. Four wideouts now for Woody Dantzler. First and 10 from the 32. Back to throw. Has a lot of air under this one, and it is complete to Gardner. Rod Gardner turns the defensive back around into the sun and brings it down at the 27-yard line. It's a 41-yard hookup.
Yeah, well, you know, we talked about this in our open. Guys on the edge for Tech. Had to make some plays. See, he's kind of feeling me. He turns, never locates the ball. That's a fantastic adjustment.
Turning Tillman around. That's his first catch of the day. He needs four to tie the record set by Tony Horn for most catches in a season. Here's Rambert again, straight ahead to the 22. This is the second series we've seen Rambert today. We've got some of the top receivers in the ACC present this afternoon. Kelly Campbell leads them all. This is yards per game. Look at Rod Gardner and Dez White at 80. Dez White, Kelly Campbell combined for 183 yards. Here's Dantzler on the corner. One to beat. Touchdown, Clemson. There'll be some points on the board today, ladies and gentlemen.
Pick number 61, Akili Smith, once again at the point of attack, bringing it.
Fourth touchdown run of the season for Woody Dantzler. Dantzler is the leading rusher for the Tigers this afternoon. Five carries, 59 yards. That one a 22-yarder for a score. Here's Romano, or rather Lazaro, for the point after. And Lazaro's kick is good. This game will not be for the faint-hearted today. 42 points already on the board. Dantzler scores to make it 28-14. Back after these messages from your local ACC station. Woodrow Dantzler puts Clemson on the board. We have 42 points on the board and only 3 minutes gone in the second quarter.
Is it too much for you?
No, not at all. Bring it on.
Do it. Buckle up.
Lazaro's kick will be fielded by White at the five. Dez White turns left and can't get around Joe Don Reams. He fought off the block and made the tackle. And a nice one in space there at the 17-yard line.
Big play for the Tigers on teams.
Tell you what. Nice four-play drive by Clemson. Took him a minute and five to execute. Dantzler, a 22-yard run. He had 134 yards of total offense so far this afternoon. And a big 42-yard pass to Rod Gardner set them up at the 27. Dantzler did the rest. First and 10. Georgia Tech at their own 16. Handoff goes to Gregory. Cuts outside and runs right into the pursuit. Carson is there to slow him up. And tracking him down, Braxton Williams, along with Keith Adams.
Oh, I love the way Adams plays the game. I mean, that's the benefit of being on defense. I mean, you can just be reckless. I mean, you play the game with such passion. You get to run and knock people out and roll, and they better get a stop. I mean, they've got to realize that the key to their success is they've got to get some stops.
They haven't stopped Georgia Tech yet this afternoon. Here comes Hamilton back to throw. Blitz is on. He throws his second incompletion of the day, intended for Kelly Campbell. He tried to throw it away from Dexter Polite.
And then we don't know, go back to Mike Hogwood's point, now we don't know if the rib injury affects his throwing motion, you know, because that he was off the mark on that. Now, you're right. Polite might have influenced that.
Third down and eight. Coming up for Georgia Tech. Three for four in third down conversions. But this is the longest third down they've had to convert to first today. Hamilton sends Wilder in motion. Looking left, throws up top, has Watkins out there, incomplete. Defending on the play was Charles Hapley, a sophomore from Pompano Beach, Florida. And I believe for the first time today, the second time today, we're going to see Dan Dyke.
They hit a game for Hapley. See, he didn't follow through on that. I think you tighten that rib vest, and it's got to restrain you a bit.
Here's Dan Dyke. Second punt of the afternoon. His first one was a beauty of about 46 yards. Travis Zachary back to return. High snap into the sun, nearly blocked. He got it. And it's down by Georgia Tech at the 29-yard line. Who got a piece of it? DeMarco Fox got in and blocked partially the punt of Dan Dyke. And Clemson's got excellent field position at the Georgia Tech 29, a net of 11 yards on the punt.
Well, your defense comes through, you get a stop. And then special teams, which started it off with a great kickoff return. Now watch this.
Oh,
boy,
yeah.
Now that's an athletic effort. You have been blocked and you're able to still extend and get a hand on the ball.
Best field position of the day for the Tigers at the 29 of Georgia Tech. Three wide outs, hand off to Zachary. Zachary runs in to Greg Gathers and then falls down. Darius Rapley also in on the play. And Dantzler on the afternoon has thrown to his tight end. And he's also run on the play fake, 22 yards for a touchdown. And Dantzler coming in relief of Brandon Streeter, who left with a dislocated hip. Second down now at 8. Quarterback draw, not much there. And what a play by Eccles. Burn Eccles. Berwyn Eccles, actually, from Atlanta.
He was tackled by number 94, Berwyn Eccles.
Dantzler on the afternoon. Who's putting up some total package yards?
Who does that remind you of? That was a Hamilton-like.
Yeah, it was. Clemson is not as married to the option as Georgia Tech is. But Dantzler's still a big part of that rushing offense. He'll carry to the corner. Myers will try to bring him down. Finally driven down by Chris Young at the 21-yard line. Gain of 6 by Woodrow Dantzler.
He's relentless. Well, here's a guy, he might as well be out in with the Park and Recreation Department right now, out playing flag. He's just balling. I mean, he's into this. You just snap it to me and I'll just take off. Snap it to me and I'll throw one downfield. I mean, he is in the flow of this game.
Tommy Bowden, you saw him on the sideline, needs his team to win one more game to get bowl eligible. Fourth down, they're going for it. Full house backfield, Dantzler, naked sweep. Dances ahead for the first down and more. At the 5, down to the 1.
He's sick.
20 yards on the carry by Woodrow Dantzler.
Oh, my goodness.
He's got 85 yards on the ground today, and he's just getting going.
The young fellas say this is sick. I mean, look at the fake. I mean, it takes some guts to carry that fake out. Now, watch this. You got me, now you don't. Man, he's a player.
Into the end zone, touchdown. Travis Zachary. The Tigers score again. And they're only 6 back, 8 back.
Oh, this is Tiger football.
Wow. Dantzler and Travis Zachary. Zachary scored 4 times against Duke last week. Here's Tony Lazara for the point after. He's starting to get busy today. Kick is up and it is good. And the Tigers are just 7 back. And we got plenty of time to play here.
Take your remote control and throw it by the couch.
9:46 left in the second. Well, this is not a game that a defensive coordinator will make a career on. 28-21, Georgia Tech, 9:46 left to go in the second quarter.
This didn't go on your resume.
Now, just say I was gone that weekend. Des White ahead over the 20 to the 22, and now looks like Clemson has got some momentum here. The Domino's Bowl Blitz sweepstakes end soon. You and a friend could win an all-expense-paid trip to four college football bowl games in 5 days, including the national championship game, January 4, 2000 in New Orleans. Register online at jpsports.com by tomorrow. I mean, there's some urgency here at 5 o'clock.
That's a hot event.
That is. Go to four games in 5 days. A lot of tailgate. First and 10, Hamilton comes out and brings Sean Gregory with him. And Keith Adams and Terry Jolly meet him right at the point of attack. No game.
Steve, I just think, like to think they need a chaperone on that trip. How about this? How about these two guys?
Wow, what a battle these guys are putting up. Dantzler has done that in just 6 minutes of action since coming in for Brandon Streeter. But Joe Hamilton's numbers are not small either. Second and nine now for the Yellow Jackets. Four wide receivers out. Passing formation here for Joe Hamilton. His pass complete to Campbell, who scored twice today. And he's close to a first down at the 31 and be a yard shy. Tackle made by Alex Ardley.
Now you simply, your Ralph Regents group for Georgia Tech, you simply want to keep possession. And let's just douse the fire. They're hot right now. Clemson's hot.
Starting,
let it wait out, yeah.
They're starting to dictate down and distance now. Here comes the third down carry, and it is going to be good for the first down. Sean Gregory is twisted around like a pretzel there by DeMarco Fox and Robert Carswell.
Joe Hamilton told us in the open about the nature of this rivalry. This would be a physical ball game. Buddy, there's been nothing but contact in this one.
Seven of the last nine have been heart-stopping finishes on the last play, either a kick or a run. Joe Hamilton's been a part of a couple of them. And he's got his team moving at their own 39-yard line, first and 10. 28-21, Georgia Tech. The motion Watkins. The option is Hamilton. He puts it on the ground. Turnover. It's going to be Clemson ball. Or did it go out of bounds first? No, Adams comes away with it. Carswell sat on it, and the Clemson defense turns the tide here with a turnover.
Yeah, that's all Tigers there. And that's what Ralph Friesen didn't want. And Joe Hamilton, I mean, Joe made a decision. That time I thought it was a bad decision. Short side, got a little bit too far upfield. Ill-advised pitch. Tigers now take possession.
Oh, Williams had his arms.
Oh, yeah, they had him.
Yeah, they had him.
And he didn't ride the mesh. Didn't ride the fullback as well as he's done in the past.
Nope. First and 10, Clemson back out in Georgia Tech territory now. And a chance to tie this thing up. Dantzler, play action. Three-step drop. He's on his way. Dantzler ahead, and he's driven out of bounds there by Edwards. One, Chris Edwards knocks him out at the 35-yard line. Edwards, the senior out of Warren, Georgia, 28 tackles. And there's Dantzler, who's done so much. He's been the spark here, accepting the responsibility after Streeter left the game.
You're just not supposed to be this good when your backup quarterback gets in the game. This is not fair.
Second down, four. Slow to the line of scrimmage and brought down. Prison, Gunter Prison was the first man to hit him.
Greg Gathers in the 2 year. Greg Gathers made a play.
Made a great play from LaPlace, Louisiana. True freshman. One of three who start on this Georgia Tech defensive unit. And again, no huddle for Clemson. Third down. Five to go. Five wideouts. Empty backfield. Save for Dantzler. Here's the pass, and it is incomplete. Intended for Rod Gardner.
I don't think old Rod wanted to run in on that one.
Got another injured player, and that is Travaris Tillman, who gets up slow, but looks like he's going to be okay. He'll come to the sideline, feeling his back.
Yeah. Thought he got kicked in the back.
Fourth down.
So he comes in. Great play on it.
Oh, yeah. By his own man.
Yeah, another foot, one of those knee pads, knees in the backs, man.
Fourth and five. Dantzler and Clemson going for it, trying to take advantage of the turnover. They're at the 35-yard line. Here's the fake reverse. Dantzler on the corner. Throws complete for the first down.
The kid is nasty.
It's to Bailey.
I mean, he just makes it look so easy. I mean, he's not rushed. He's not hurried. It's fourth down and five. Snap a little bit off to the left. Watch the poise. Look at this guy. Silky smooth. Throws the rope right on the numbers.
Big target, Matt Bailey, 6'4", 215 for his third pass of the day, or of the season. And Dantzler is sacked for the first time today by Ross Mitchell and Gunter Kreiser. Also, Chris Edwards in on the play.
Now, that'll end that. That's how you stop it.
Yeah.
I know Ross is mad at him. He's mad at him at that earlier touchdown, that play action faked it. He got sucked in. See, I like this again. Ted Roof, send your boys. You've had success when you blitzed it. You got to keep the pressure on Woodrow Dantzler.
Try to stop Clemson on first down, Ted Roof said yesterday. Make them three and out 50% of the time. That hasn't happened yet. Here's the pass complete to Mal Lawyer at the 12. Actually, the 13-yard line brought down there by Ross Mitchell. Also tackled by Chris Young, but it's a nice gain on the play of 15 yards. And it gets Clemson down inside the 15. Dantzler on the day, 5 of 6, 103 yards and a touchdown. There's Ted Roof making his call.
You know, Ted, he knocked me out when he was here.
Third down and two. Clemson in tight. Handoff goes to Zachary. First down. Shoestring tackle doesn't succeed, and Zachary is down at the one-yard line. Chris Edwards finally brought him down. Zachary tried to stretch along the end zone and get the ball in there, but he lost possession of it.
I want you to watch the handoff. Look what Dantzler does to make this play. Now that's an effort.
Wow.
I mean, that's an effort. That could have been a fumble. He gets it there. Zachary holds on, and it shows you that the kid has passion trying to get in the end zone.
Well, the train almost left without him. Here is Dantzler in the end zone. Touchdown, Clemson, but a flag down. There's a flag on the play, and it's going to be against Clemson. So call this touchdown back, and Tommy Bowden really upset.
Well, that's why they're so intense, because he's intense. I like that.
Here's Robin Wood.
Illegal shift on the offense. 5 yards.
Tommy Bowden beside himself.
Well, he's got a young squad, so he's got to whip these guys into it. He's got to keep the level going. You're on the road. You were trailing. You know, he's got to keep that going.
You don't want to settle for three here. You got to match Georgia Tech 6 for 6. Travis Zachary, the setback. He gets the handoff. Cuts across the grain and gets down to the one.
Man, that's physical running. Well, that's between the tackles, man. You can't be ordinary and run between the tackles. You have to be special to do that. And you can talk about the size of this offensive line for Clemson as you look at the numbers. 6 yards per tote. That is big time.
Touchdown today. Here's Dantzler going over.
No.
He didn't get there.
No.
So it'll be third down. One goal.
Coach
Darren Echols on the tackle.
Coach is saying, lower your pads, guys. Low man wins.
Clemson trying to punch this one in after they picked up the fumble. Here comes a handoff. Zachary, touchdown, Clemson. No flags. Tigers now close to within a point.
Steve, there's so much you can say about points following turnovers. It demoralizes your opponent.
Second touchdown of the day for Zachary, but it took something extraordinary to happen, and Clemson forced a turnover. There's the kick by Lazara, and we've got a tie ball game. 4:45 left to go in the second quarter. Let's watch it again. Zachary just dives over the pile.
Kyle Young up front, the center.
So Clemson and Georgia Tech have gotten together, put 56 points on the board, and we're not even at halftime. ACC fans, visit participating JCPenney locations in your area for your official ACC collection merchandise. Look the part of an ACC fan in style at JCPenney and the ACC collection. Travis Zachary's second touchdown push of the day. For Zachary on the season, that's his 13th. Here's our Cross Creek scoreboard. Arkansas has a lead over third-ranked Tennessee. Florida with a field goal in Columbia against South Carolina. Michigan State and Northwestern scoreless at first. Now to the Big Ten. Michigan still has a field goal lead. And Illinois, a vastly underappreciated team, with a big lead on Ohio State. Indiana by four over Minnesota. Big day in college football. Some major statements will be made, and one is being made here. This time by Clemson.
Yeah, hard to get better than this, Devo.
This one goes into the end zone. Amazingly, things are starting to go Clemson's way this time. Lazara kicks it into the end zone. Dez White will not be able to bring it back. And Georgia Tech now will start at their own 20-yard line. And you got to say something about Clemson's defense now. They're starting to put Joe Hamilton in obvious pass situation.
Yeah, they got to stop. Confidence is there.
Let's go to the sidelines of Mike Hogwood.
On the Clemson sideline, you can really notice the shift in momentum. But what I'm impressed about Clemson, they never got down when they were down 28-7. Kept their heads up. It showed the game is tied.
First and 10. Georgia Tech. Play fake. And here's the pass. It is complete to Kelly Campbell. Ooh, he is drilled at the 33. It's a gain of 13. But the hitting goes on for Clemson.
Oh brother. Man, I just love that. You know, you expect good teams. They'll catch their passes on you. But we watch average teams let guys catch it, and they don't finish. But that's finishing there. I don't care how good you are. Kevin Campbell's excellent, but he won't forget that hit.
No, he won't. First and 10 at the 33-yard line. White split one way. John Myers the other. Here's the option to Hamilton, and Hamilton gets ahead to about the 39-yard line, and it'll be a gain of about five on the play. And you got to wonder with those ribs now, how much can he call his own number?
Well, he left his fullback, and the thing on that play is that Joe had big old Ed Wilder out there running, and you want to stay with that.
Look at the second quarter, almost a complete reversal of the first. Tech owned the first quarter. Clemson right now in ownership of the second. Georgia Tech looking at second down and five. Handoff goes to Gregory. Gregory, big hole. First down at the Clemson 49-yard line. Carswell with the tackle. Unofficially his fourth of the day.
That's a statement. That is a statement run. That tells you that Key and Noah, King and Burke, those guys are getting it done already. Saying, wait a minute, guys. Let's hang in there.
Well, we got to stop them, he's saying. And that's a 12-yard gain, and we have a player down. And it looks like one of the interior linemen here for Georgia Tech. That might be Noah King. Yes, it is. Yeah. Their center.
Number 71, Noah King.
David Schmidgall is their backup center. He's a junior, 275. And King looks to be in a lot of pain out there. Well, the last 3 years have been close finishes between these two, and this one looks like it's tilting in that direction. Clemson and Georgia Tech, let's take you back to 96. Nealon Green, one-yard touchdown plunge, 4:10 remaining. Clemson wins by three. In 97, Brad Chambers, 20-yard field goal, under two to play. Tech wins 23-20. And how about last year? Joe Burns, one-yard run in the final minute. Tech winner 24-21. Who will prevail today? The one thing that's different today, they were scoring in the 20s those last 3 years. They're already there, and we're yet to go to intermission.
And this evening, it might as well be zip-zip. And there's injury factor now. We've lost a starting quarterback. May have a starting center out of the ballgame. There have been collisions and great special teams play.
There's Schmidgall working out with Joe Hamilton, taking a couple snaps on the sideline as Noah King comes off the field with assistance and in a lot of pain.
Yeah. It's not the snap under center. I worry about the shotgun.
Yeah. And Georgia Tech uses it a lot. So we'll see. Watch carefully the center quarterback exchange here. 3:34 left to go in the second quarter. Clemson and Georgia Tech are tied at 28. Steve Martin, Doc Walker, Mike Hogwood, we hope you're enjoying the action as much as we are. Andrew Jeske sets up on the left side of the formation as a tight end. He's already caught a touchdown pass today. Here's White in motion. Here's Hamilton. Carrying. Hamilton squirts free and puts the ball ahead. Down to the 44-yard line of Clemson.
Just getting to know you at the end of that play.
What's it like to tackle a Heisman candidate?
Well, you know, you just want to make sure that you greet him properly. and he gets down there and watches at the end. That's a hello.
Hello. Yeah, Braxton Williams. I just want to make sure you didn't get up again.
Well, see, Braxton said, remember the K.
Braxton K. Williams.
Yeah, that's what you're whispering in his ear.
Got a touchdown. Fake field goal earlier this season. Here comes a handoff. There's DeGregory. And Gregory ahead. He's close to the first down, but it'd be a little bit short at the 40-yard line. He needs to move the football beyond the 39. And Jason Holloman is in on the stop for the Clemson Tigers. You see the timeouts left for both.
See, I like the pace of this drive for Tech. This is what they started prior to their fumble. You know, you want to control this. You want to gnaw away in the middle and set them up for the big one over the top.
Third down and inches.
Oh, they blew this.
Yep. Flag down on the play. They were not in concert that time. Stops the clock with 2:06 remaining, but this will make third and two or third and one into third and six. It's a chess match between Ralph Regan and Reggie Herring.
Oh, yeah. That's the beauty of it. Hard to trick a team that goes off no huddle every day in practice. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They see this every day.
Third down and six. And White are split wide to the top side. Myers and Watkins are to the near side of the field. That's Watkins. He'll join the other two up to the top. Here's the pass, tip, and intercepted. Carswell picks off the pass. Tackled by Myers. It's the second turnover by the Yellow Jackets this afternoon. Clemson leading the ACC in interceptions, and they have just picked up their 18th. They came into this game fourth in the NCAA, and Carswell has picked off his sixth of the year.
That's just winning football. I mean, on a tip, it's anybody's ball. And we'll find out if this was a good decision by Joe Hamilton. Pretty good pass pro. Yeah, boy, you tip them up from an offensive standpoint, most chances you lose.
Dantzler at quarterback. Play fake, rolling out. Wants to throw and does to Sir Gallus. There's a flag on the play. Collins drives him out in Georgia Tech territory at the 46, but a flag may call it back. The initial indication is holding. Holding against the defense.
Ooh.
Well, let's see. The play may have gone as long as the penalty would. And here's Robin Wood to make the call.
Holding defense. The penalty's declined. First down.
Tommy Bowden says we already got the first.
All right, let's see this. Little contact. Well, he's being driven on that.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. That's tough. Now, that is very tough. I mean, the guy was being taken advantage of.
At the 46, Dantzler with a quick fake, pump, and go to the top. He's got Gardner out there, but it's defended nicely by Tillman. A ball that hung up under too much air at the 10-yard line.
Number 26.
Boy, you need to change the pace now. If you're the Yellow Jacket. So that means the ball's up in the air and a pretty good rush on this. You get a good little finish at the end. I think that was Clay Brooks. Now watch this. So you got to catch that ball. In a game like this, when it's slipping away, momentum slipping away, you need to make a big play.
Second down and 10. There's the pitch to Zachary. He scored twice. Big hole between the tackles.
Good tackle.
And he's brought down by Chris Young.
That was a securing tackle by Young. That might have gone open the gate. The gate was there.
The ability for Georgia Tech to stop this team will be based on their ability to make tackles in space.
Absolutely right.
Tommy Bowden addressed that before the game with us today. Third down and three. Here's Dantzler straight ahead.
He hit.
He's going to be short. Coming up with the play, Wimbush. And also Merrick Watson.
Well, Ricardo brought the mallet on that play.
Yes, he did. True freshman out of Blakely, Georgia, one of three who starts for Ted Roof's defense. Fourth down and a yard. Clemson going for it. One time they went for it and scored a touchdown.
Hey, eye formation.
Ooh, and Eccles is in early. There's a flag on the play. Now, was he drawn by the center? Or did he jump prematurely? Clock shows 20 seconds left in the half.
Woodrow Dantzler.
Offside on the defense.
You think he got him with a cadence?
Oh, he got it. Woodrow, you're too young to have these many skills, my friend. Yeah, he worked it.
That gives Clemson a first down.
Let's watch this. Watch his head. See, he barked that out. Yeah, he worked it.
Oh, yeah.
I love that, man.
Eccles bought it, didn't he?
Old Rich Rodriguez, their coordinator, has got to be tickled to death that a kid can pick up. Those are the small things, the intangibles that are about playing the position of quarterback.
Clemson with a timeout. They've got two remaining. 20 seconds left to go. They're 33 yards away from a go-ahead score here. And also, you got to think that a field goal will work, too. Of course, down to the 33, you got to probably get down to the 25. Lazara's range is 43 yards. There's Rick Stockstill in the middle of the offensive huddle. In the ACC standings, two teams battling for second. Clemson has already beaten Virginia. Georgia Tech lost to the Cavaliers a week ago. The Clemson win gives them undisputed hold on second spot behind Florida State. And really puts Clemson in line not only for a bowl, but possibly a Gator Bowl. And look at the strength of schedule. So Clemson is used to taking on the top Timber. They've faced Florida State, the top team in the country, lost by six. And they lost narrowly to Virginia Tech, a team they were in the battle with up until the last couple of minutes up in Blacksburg. Virginia Tech number three.
Yeah, the key is that three of the four teams that they've challenged and come up short against are still undefeated.
That's right.
Now that says volumes, man. You're playing good people, you play hard, and you're in the games in the fourth quarter.
Rick Stock still in the huddle there with Dantzler. Tommy Bowden watching on. And next week we've got a choice for you. Actually not a choice, depending on where you live, what game you'll see. Some of you will see live from Chapel Hill the battle for the bell. Duke and North Carolina going at it at Keenan Stadium at 12 noon. Bill Dooley and I will be there.
The coach.
Coach. You're exactly right. And next week, of course, some of you will see the Virginia-Maryland game. Mike Hogwood, Doc Walker will bring you that one at high noon from Bird Stadium in College Park. Check your local listings for the game to be seen in your area. ACC football from Jefferson Pilot Sports at high noon.
Coach Dooley's my guy. I mean, you know, I have to lean in whenever he talks. I got my little notepad out, taking notes, just saying, hey, Coach, what about this? He breaks it down for me. I love the guy, man.
Well, the fashion police haven't been here yet. You can see by that last shot. But, yeah, the thing about Coach Dooley that is so great to see is when he goes and talks with the coaches from the other team.
Oh, he's a legend. What are you talking about?
They'll tell him everything. I mean, if he asked, they'd give them his financial information. I mean, he can get them to say anything to him.
And that's the fraternity, man. And, you know, he's with the dean.
All right. Now they're adding time on the clock. They say that 20 seconds is not accurate, and they've added 7 seconds. And that's got to be a big help for Clemson here. Although neither team has taken long to score. Clemson at the 33, slightly out of the field goal range of Tony Lazara. He's hit one of 43.
I doubt if they ever think about field goals with this group.
Haven't had to today.
They may settle for one.
The punters are getting bored. Dantzler. Rolls right, big rush on, hit as he let it go. Recovered by Clemson, the pressure by Greg Gathers. What a year this freshman is having.
Greg, my man, where has that been all day? I mean, he exploded off the line of scrimmage. You talk about getting around the corner. I mean, Akili Smith, man, you got to throw something into this guy. I mean, he was out there playing the hands game.
Strong candidate for ACC Rookie of the Year. We've got another timeout here, and this one's going to be taken by Clemson. They're down to one. As you look at Greg Gathers, that's his 15th tackle for loss this season and his fifth sack of the year. So he's piling up some big numbers for Rookie of the Year.
Well, that's 4-7 speed coming around the corner. I mean, with attitude, but he turned it up a notch. That's what coaches want to get guys to play like every stinking play.
Well, every play is important, and this game is important, so important. Coach George O'Leary talked about the vital attitude of this game today.
I tell you, when you're coming off a tough loss, you want to play a great opponent. I think Clemson coming here is a great game for Georgia Tech, and it's going to be a great game, you know, versus Clemson, because there's a lot riding on this game.
A lot riding and a lot of truth in that statement, because this has been a great game here in the first half. Georgia Tech got out to a 28-7 lead. Clemson is trying to cash in on the second Yellow Jacket turnover of the day.
Well, Steve, when you're, as a coach, when you play a good opponent, you don't have to throw a hand grenade in the locker room to get them to come out for practice. Because they want to play in the game.
Second down and 19. Ball at the 41. They're well out of Lazara's range now. Dantzler trying to pick it up. Goes long. Has Mal Lawyer. It's incomplete. He was out of bounds when he caught it. He made a great catch on the play. But unfortunately, the ball was too tall and took him out of bounds.
Man, he threw it right in the donut of the zone coverage. And it's not a lot of room. Wow. He got it in just a little bit out of bounds.
He had some mustard on it, too.
He could throw it. And they say Willie Simmons can throw it.
Third down, 19. 13 seconds left to go. Clemson down to one timeout. Here's Dantzler to throw. It is complete to Watts, and he gets out of bounds at the 34-yard line. He'll be short of the first down. It's a pickup of 7 on the play. It'll bring up fourth down and 12. And this may be the best they can do. They're still at the 34. You add 7 and then add 10. You got a 51-yard kick. And so Clemson will talk it over with their final timeout. And 8 seconds left to go on the clock.
It's fourth down and 12. I feel like we've done a whole game. Here we are, not even half. We haven't even had a hot dog yet.
No, we plan to change that soon, but it's been a delay. And it's been a delight to do this one. Clemson and Georgia Tech tied at 28. Clemson was up 21 to nothing. Then 28 to 7. And Clemson came roaring back. Two Travis Zachary 1-yard runs following a Woody Dantzler 22-yard run. Three unanswered scores to tie it up at 28. The last one taking advantage of a Georgia Tech fumble. This one trying to take advantage of Robert Carswell's 6th interception of the year. And these two, amazingly enough, have been the longest drives of this game. These two teams have been scoring and taking no more than 90 seconds to do it.
It's had everything. And now it's probably had a little bit too much for Georgia Tech in terms of turnovers.
Yes.
I mean, that's where they've got to look at theirself. They got to get into halftime and say, hey, we're better than that offensively. You know, let's play and do it our way.
Here comes Clemson. Dantzler out there. They're going to go for it. They have 8 seconds left. A sideline pattern in and out. Gets them a first down and possibly 2 seconds left on the clock. Four wide receivers. Back to throw. Here's Dantzler. Dantzler going for it all. Throws it up in the end zone. Bailey is there. It is tipped out of the end zone.
That was smart.
And time expires.
Chris Young, he did it right. I mean, you swat that thing away with authority.
305 yards to 325 yards total offense, Clemson and Georgia Tech. Here's Clemson with a kickoff return. Wofford gets up to the 30-yard line.
Yeah,
and Wofford, yeah, he looks like he's hurt.
Oh, he's taking a beating. Yeah, I mean, three big-time collisions.
25 yards on the return by Wofford. And we've had some people really hit hard.
Number 25, Brian Wofford, shaking up for Clemson.
You have to be reckless to be a return guy. And here he kind of gets through it, thinks he's got an opening. And, boy, that's a helmet right on the kneecap. I'll tell you what, that Rhino, he has been a big factor on teams all day long for the Yellow Jackets.
Ellie Rhino with the hit, and you can see that Brian Wofford's in a lot of pain. Both teams have had to do without. Clemson's already lost a quarterback.
And a lot of time, watch the contact. Rydell to kneecap.
Oh.
Ah.
There's padding there, but it didn't help.
Not a lot. Despite the fact you end up, you land on the back of your head. That's why weight training, conditioning, that's why this sport is so violent. And what it requires such a commitment from you physically because it hits like that.
Kelly Rhino is the man who made the hit on special teams. He probably feels good about the hit, but I'm sure he feels somewhat concerned for.
Yeah, you don't want to take people out.
No.
You want them in pain,
yeah,
but you don't want to take them out.
And he's in a lot of pain, and that would cut down half of Clemson's outstanding receiver duo, Wofford, this season. He's had a great year. 50 passes that he's caught, 625 yards. The punters were active early for Clemson, but he sat down in the second quarter. Three downs and out the first two, but then look at the positive yardage rolled up after that. On the third series, that's where Dantzler took over. After the third series, Streeter went out of the ball game with the dislocated hip. He'll not return and likely is done for the season.
Well, look what you have out. Streeter, 1,100 yards in the air. Watford has, you know, 625 yards. He's three scores. And you mentioned his 50 receptions. I mean, that's tough for a coach now. Rodriguez had to think, okay, I've replaced Streeter with Dantzler.
Yeah.
But now outside, as you mentioned, what do I do when I want to go four POs, four wide outs?
Well, he's got Matt Bailey, who caught a ball earlier today, and Mal Lawyer and Rod Gardner and Justin Watts, who've caught passes. And here comes the no-huddle offense for its first try of the second half. Gardner is split wide to the right, Justin Watts wide to the left. High backfield for only the second time today. A pitch to Zachary, who scored twice, and he runs headlong into Ross Mitchell.
Ross.
Mitchell did a nice job fighting off a block to make the tackle at the 32-yard line.
Ross has been very active, redshirt sophomore. And when you play that spot inside for the Yellow Jackets, yeah, that shows you're a man. I mean, that's the old home of Batman and Robbins. Brookings, you know what I mean? And those guys are nuts.
And he played behind Matt Yurimovich.
That's right, Yurimovich, another maniac.
Went out with an injury. Injuries have decimated this Georgia Tech defense. And sometimes they show up here in this game. Zachary between the tackles, a little bit of running room up to the 36-yard line. And Greg Gathers is there for the stop, among others.
Talk about the offensive line at Clemson. You have to be athletic. They don't have a 300-pounder, but they have athletes. They're 61. You see Smith once again. Just a little bit of a knock, but he's able to pull and make it happen.
Third down and four. Dantzler's going to run. Big block on the corner, but a big tackle. And it is going to be Merrick Watson diving over the pile to stop Woodrow Dantzler. And for the first time this afternoon, with Dantzler as quarterback, the Tigers will punt.
Well, huge stop. Great position by Ross Mitchell, the outside backer. Never gave up contain.
Ryan Romano is there to kick. Marvius Hester will be back to receive. And so Georgia Tech has stopped Clemson for the first time since the first quarter. Line drive kick returnable by Hester at the 26. Gets a block at the 33 up to the 36-yard line. And Hester, who averages 14 yards a punt, is taken down by Vince Churchill. He has 14 that time after the 37-yard kick by Ryan Romano. And Joe Hamilton back out on the scene. There's what he's done today. Only two punts, but the last two possessions are not what George O'Leary wants to see.
Yeah, the interception and the fumble. I mean, that's been the wart.
First and 10 for the 36. Blitz is on. Adams has him in the grasp at the 33-yard line.
You think O'Keefe has some incentive out of College Park, Georgia? He talked about it all week. I mean, he took this personal. I mean, he wanted to show the coaches here that he could play the game, and that's a ferocious approach. He went right through the back.
That sets a new record at Clemson for tackles for loss. That's his 28th of the season. Pass is complete to Kelly Campbell. And Campbell fights for yardage at the 42-yard line. And that is a 9-yard reception. And that is not only a Clemson record, but it is an ACC record. And it's set by two Clemson players. And that's not a good sign at all. Wofford being helped to the field house very, very slowly and favoring that tender right knee that met head-on with the helmet of Kelly Rhino.
Third down. I hope it's just a kneecap, a bruise of a kneecap.
Third down and six. Score tied at 28. Hamilton on the gun. Oh, he threaded the needle to Dez White for the first down at midfield. Dextra Paul White was all over.
Boy, that's a courage throw. Now, you watch this. You know you have to get vertical. You got to get up. You snap it off. Keep the shoulders. Try to turn them. Ball right on the numbers. Polite's in position. Excellent throw by the Heisman candidate, Joe Hamilton.
Hamilton, 14 of 18 on the day. 251 yards, three touchdowns, one interception. First and 10 at the 49. Lots of movement. And there are no flags. The ball was snapped. Players apparently got back before the ball was snapped, and they're going to get a gain on the yard of about 6 yards. And here's Wofford.
Yeah. See, again, that's that high quarterback IQ where you utilize the voice inflection. You take advantage, man. Those, again, we talked about the intangibles. Well, of course, the senior, Hamilton, has the whole package.
Hamilton looking at second down and four. Noah King is back in there at center. He left with an injury in the first half. Hamilton rushed, gets out of the pocket, and is brought down at the 38-yard line. He has got the first down. Goes down in the tackle of Keith Adams.
All right, you watch again. There's Noah King, big number 71. Happy to have him back in there. Do you get the pump? And boy, I mean, that's a stiff arm on a pretty large individual now. We're not talking about no basic guy. 285-pounder. Talking about a load.
First and 10 at the 38. Hamilton to throw. Off play action. Pass is complete to Campbell. Campbell down to near the 20-yard line. Actually at the 22. It's a gain of 17 on the play. Kelly Campbell has had an active day this afternoon. Campbell's already caught 2 touchdown passes. This one put Georgia Tech up 14-0. Nice fade route thrown by Joe Hamilton. Oh, he wasn't done. Very next possession. Off play action. 42 yards out. It's Hamilton to Campbell for his second touchdown pass of the day. Joe Hamilton has thrown 3 on the afternoon. First and 10. On the option, the pitch fumbled, picked up, and lost out of bounds. It was not in anybody's possession, and the last team to possess it was Georgia Tech. Close call for Clemson.
Short side option. This time Hamilton makes a good read. That ball is there. Got to catch it. You can't look upfield. Yeah, there are going to be people there. You know that Broderick will be in your face.
Wow, Carson almost picked that ball up. That would have been the third Georgia Tech turnover. Third in as many series. Eighth play of the drive, however. Second down and 11. The throw. The pass is complete to Watkins, and he's wrestled down at the 18-yard line. A gain of 5. Chad Carson makes sure it stays just that.
Well, Reggie Herring, defensive coordinator for Clemson, he's going to bring the backer. And Joe picked it up. It was a hot read. He knew exactly where to go with the football, but it limits what they'd like to do. What do you think that is, Steve?
I think he's got the steel side.
Oh, that's a Batman look. I like the eyes on that.
Campbell, White, and Watkins are all split to the same side. Third down and 6. Score tied. Georgia Tech driving. Here's Hamilton. The throw is over the head of Kerry Watkins.
Oh, boy. He had some money out there. Terry Bryant with a nice little rush, but he had some money on the sidelines. Joey just missed him.
And he knows it. See the reaction? The field goal unit is on now. Luke Manjay is on to attempt a field goal of 36 yards. His longest this season is 43. He's 7 for 10. Out of the hold of George Godsey. Here's the first field goal attempt of the day, and it is good. And Georgia Tech has the lead once again. With 9:25 left to go in the third quarter, Manjay from 36 yards out, Georgia Tech by a field goal. Welcome back to Bobby Dodd Stadium, historic Grant Field in Atlanta, site of a whole bunch of offense here this afternoon. 59 points, in fact. Luke Manjay, there you see him getting ready to kick. He just booted a 36-yard field goal. And we are underway once more. Steve Martin, Doc Walker, Mike Hogwood here in Atlanta. Here comes the kick, and it is taken by Joe Don Reams, and he is advised and counseled wisely not to bring it out. Your source for sports on the internet, jpsports.com, is now online. Each week, we'll bring you previews of our upcoming telecast and in-depth coverage of the ACC. For the inside scoop, log on to jpsports.com and see the picture
Hogwood
of Mike Hogwood.
Franchise.
You can just pretend you're being interviewed by him.
Yeah.
It's a thrill not everybody gets.
You're right.
First and 10 from the 20. Four wide outs now for Woody Dantzler. Dantzler wants to run. They've got a block on Gathers. He'll step inside it and get a little bit of running room. Felipe Claybrooks comes up with a stop. Georgia Tech's had to move some people around because of the injuries to Yuremovich. They moved Rogers back into a linebacker spot, and Felipe Claybrooks, who you just saw, is now a regular starter at defensive end. Second down and seven. Dantzler spring out. Fires on the run, incomplete. Intended for Joe Don Reams and Jeremy Myers. True freshman making the play. He's had a couple of nice hits there.
Yeah, he has. He's very physical. Gets there that time, you know, you want to come around and try to rake that ball out of the receiver's hand.
His older brother, John Myers, is a wide receiver. There's Jeremy Myers from Stone Mountain, Georgia. Crowd is up. There's not a seat left. Hottest ticket in town, and they're watching Clemson. On third and seven, from their own 23, out of the shotgun. Dantzler running away from Claybrooks. The pass is complete. And it's brought down by Joe Don Reams, but it's not going to be close to the first down. He gets to the 27. Gain on the play of about four. Jeremy Myers again with another stop. And Clemson, for the second straight time, is three downs and out.
Oh, Myers might have been a little banged up on that play, but, buddy, he played it smart. Kept the angle in. Good defensive series.
Tell me, after 59 points, you're going to see a defensive struggle.
Well, we might. We need some halftime adjustments. Off the wall.
Romano gets a good one off. This is Marvius Hester from the 23. Hester looking to pick up blockers. There's not many there. He's brought down by Chad Speck, among others. Gets out to the 31-yard line. And that's his fourth special teams tackle. A 48-yard punt returns 7 yards. It's 31-28. Georgia Tech has the ball. Georgia Tech has the football. First and 10 at their own 27-yard line. Here's Joe Hamilton at work. Play action, going back to throw, and he wants Watkins, or rather Campbell. And he is caught in a foot race there with Dextre Polite. Well, we talk about the Heisman race and what it's coming down to. You see Joe Hamilton, Peter Warwick, Ron Dayne, and Drew Brees, the four players most mentioned. Now, one thing you've got to remember with Joe Hamilton's yardage, you also have to add the fact that he's gained 516 yards and has a 4.7-yard average on the ground.
Yeah, another five touchdowns rushing. Exactly. So, I mean, I don't know. I don't know how you don't put this guy one or two, but again, he still has some more ball games.
Exactly. He's got this one and two more beyond it. Wake Forest and Georgia waiting on the schedule. And now a timeout taken by the Yellow Jackets. And one that they, I don't think, wanted to burn right there at the 7:52 mark.
Tough to figure those out. Change of possession. You come out, and then you don't know where you want to go.
Well, coming up next week, you will see one of two ball games, Virginia and Maryland at College Park. You get a chance to see Thomas Jones, who's also a candidate for the Heisman, and Lamont Jordan, an outstanding running back with two of the top three in the league. Or some of you will go to Chapel Hill with us and see the Duke Blue Devils, who are leading against Wake Forest, take on the North Carolina Tar Heels, who had an emotional win Thursday in Charlotte, North Carolina, against the North Carolina State Wolfpack. That's coming your way. There's John Heisman's name. He coached here for 16 years. Here's statue. Guards the entrance to historic Grant Field, and he would look down with approval on what Joe Hamilton has done, not only this year, but throughout his career. Second down now, and 10. Hamilton on the option. Hamilton tucks it under, but it is met by Keith Adams and Terry Jolly.
Adams. Steve, he's just somebody you have to have somebody on him at all times.
And this is the concern that Reggie Herring had, the option, trying to take it away and also keep track of Dez White and Kelly Campbell.
They've lost confidence, Steve, in the option. Georgia Tech has had a couple of fumbles. They've lost confidence.
Adams from Metro Atlanta in College Park. Here's Hamilton back to throw. Rushes on with a blitz. He slips through it. Now it heads for the corner. Gets a block there. Has the first down and wisely gets out of bounds at the 38-yard line.
Ed Wilder. My goodness. That was a hello man block on this play. Talk about how good this young man is at quarterback. I mean, just watch how good he is. There he gets a good drop. He wants to go for the long ball. realizes the pressure, feels it. Now watch him. Still tries to run. Makes you miss. There's Kay Williams, and there's the block.
Oh, boy. And remind you that he's doing this on very sore ribs. First and 10 after the gain of 13 or 14 on the play to the 38-yard line. Hand off Gregory. Cuts between tackles, and he picks up some nice yardage. Carswell helps bring him down. There are others, Braxton K. Williams and Keith Adams, in on the play.
Oh, Gregory is a tough guy. I mean, we just lost a great back in Walter Payton. And this is what Payton would do. Walter would deliver the blow as a running back, and that's special.
Second down and one, the gain by 9 by Gregory. Three down for Joe Hamilton. Don't want to give him too many of these. At the 47. Hamilton against the blitz. Pass complete. It's to Campbell.
Can't defend that.
That's his 7th reception of the day at the Georgia Tech, or rather at the Clemson, 46.
Steve, you can't defend that. If you go on a straight, he threw the ball behind him. I mean, it's a designated throw as a defender. There's another little hello from Mr. Hamilton. But watch this up top. I mean, I like this. That ball goes the opposite side. If you're Dexter Polite, what do? You're caught in no man's land.
Yeah, you're just being driven off the ball and you're recovering. Troy Bodman had Hamilton in his sights. Campbell, 7 catches, 125 yards. Here's the pass complete to Gregory. Gregory in open space, brought down there by Kenzie Ross. A 16-yard gain for another Yellow Jacket first down.
Joe Hamilton has great touch, but Dez White, the man on your screen, is responsible for this play. He's the influence guy. He's your go-to, your big hitter. Beautiful touch on the swing right. What you don't see is Dez White, who's taking the cross on the post. Took a lot of folk with him.
Talk about yards after the catch. Gregory has 2 catches, 72 yards, 1 for 56. Plays just like that. First and 10 at the 29. Here's Dez White in motion. Hamilton straight ahead. Right after his fullback, and he goes straight ahead down to the 27-yard line. It'll be a gain of about 3 yards. Let's take a look at our Pizza Hut scoreboard. I don't believe this. And Duke leading Wake Forest 34-0. That could be an important verdict. That's it, still in the second quarter. I still don't believe this. I thought Virginia would be up by 40. And Tennessee, yeah, Tennessee's come back.
And the Vols.
And Florida struggling, but they lead South Carolina. Michigan on top of Penn State in the third. Michigan State with a 17-point lead at the half against Northwestern. 8th play of the drive, Hamilton throws. He has a pass out there to the corner. It is incomplete. It is intended, it looks like, for Watkins. Boy, there was a lot of pushing going on out there. Dexter Polite and Kelly Campbell.
Yeah, but Kerry has some pushing, too. You know, you can push on offense. Now, nice stem on the route. There he kind of telegraphs he's slowing down. He actually pushes off. You'd be wanting to be honest about it. Dexter Polite's in good position. You can't telegraph when you're going to slow your route down. You see him start to let you know that he's going to stop.
Yeah. Georgia Tech 6 out of 10 on third down conversions. They face 3rd and 7 here at the Clemson 26. Up by a field goal. Blitz is on. Has the time. The pass complete to Campbell. Inside the 20 to the 16-yard line. We got a flag down, however, on the field.
Yeah, involved the inside receiver. Kerry Watkins is involved in this.
This is going to be an 11-yard gain, but it could be wiped out. Let's see what's called. Robin Wood and his officials. And it's against Clemson.
Face mask.
So the first down stands, and there's more yardage to come. Tommy Bowden needs a stop from his defensive unit. Clemson needs a win to be bowl eligible. They're at 5-4 right now, and they have South Carolina remaining on the schedule. Here's the call.
During the pass, there was a 5-yard face mask against the defense. The penalty would have been penalized from the previous spot. The end of the play results in a longer game, so the penalties decline.
Usually you don't get that kind of detail. We thank Robin Wood for that.
Yeah, we liked it. Very well done.
So Tech declines. They've got the ball at the 16-yard line.
All right, let's check the inside receiver. Let's see if we find it. Well, yeah. Fox grabs it on the outside.
First and 10. Hamilton changing up. Got a tight end on the right, and he repositions Campbell to the wide side of the field. Play clock down to 6. He gets it off. Aiming for Campbell? No. Didn't get it. And now we got another flag. Terry Jolly may have gotten a late hit in on Joe Hamilton.
Now, Jolly's been close on a couple of occasions. Yeah, Reggie Herring is pleading his case.
Half the distance to the goal and first down.
A costly penalty on the Tigers. Half the distance, first down. It'll take it to the 8.
Yeah. And you can't have that out of a junior. Now, I like this kid. I think he's a heck of a player. All right, you know he's thrown. Sees the club. Come on.
Yeah.
Come on, Terry.
That pass was long gone, yeah. Although we didn't show it in real time. 10th play of the drive at the 8-yard line. First and goal. Georgia Tech trying to take this game by the throat. Campbell in motion. Here comes a handoff. Gregory almost bobbled it. He is driven back.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. That's Carswell. Hit him at the point of attack. And Alex Ardley. Robert Carswell made the big hit. Ardley helped out. They were waiting for Sean Gregory.
Yeah. See, that's what I want. I want to see some bounce in your step. Win, lose, or draw, man. Play that. We'll talk about an exchange. That was almost disastrous. But bring the Rydells.
A 2-yard loss thanks to that man, Robert Carswell. Second down and goal from the 10. Wilder and Gregory are in the I formation behind Hamilton. Here's the option. Hamilton sneaks his way through. Almost had the ball stripped that time. Charles Hapley is in on the tackle in the near strip as he gained maybe a yard to the 9.
Free, hey, you see the lack of air of confidence? You agree with me on that? I mean, you get tentative.
Yep.
You just get tentative. He does not run that thing like we've seen him run it in the past. So Ralph's trying to figure out now, what do I do? Quarterback draw? Do I let it give him a chance at the fade?
Myers and White are split wide to one side. To the short side, it's Campbell and Watkins. 4 wide receivers out of the shotgun. 3rd and goal from the 9. Tech trying to score. They do. Watkins from 9 yards out. The 4th touchdown pass of the day for Joe Hamilton.
Well, that's strong. Now, he had options on this. Where's the pass rush if you're a Tiger fan? He's sitting back there figuring it out. Nice route, good separation, good throw and catch.
Here comes the kick after touchdown, Luke Manger. Had a busy day today. A field goal and now the extra point. And Georgia Tech increases that lead to 10. 38-28, Yellow Jackets over the Tigers. Will return after these messages from your local ACC station. Welcome back to Georgia Tech. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets up by 10. 3:32 left to go here in the 3rd. Luke Manger with the kick. Now, the injury to Brian Wofford has changed things as far as the kick return team is concerned. Joe Don Reams is back there. Wofford, of course, one of the leading kick returners in the ACC. Here's Reams to get this one at the 1. Sets the wedge and gets hit at the 15-yard line.
Man. Woo-hoo. Do they play teams?
And that is Kelly Rhino again.
Rhino. Nut. Absolute nut.
Here's another look at our Bank of America ACC Salute to Excellence question. Which ACC school became the league's first to win at least 7 football games 12 years in a row? Virginia. Cavaliers posted a 9-3 overall mark last season to establish that outstanding record. You knew that all along.
Oh, yeah. We're talking about consistency.
Yep.
Cavaliers.
You'll get to see them next week. Dantzler back on 1st and 10. In trouble? Out of trouble. And ahead for extra yards to the 21-yard line. It'll be a gain. It'll be a gain of 5.
Time. Woodrow just said, okay, let me just take this. Let's get back out to the schoolyard and let me dominate.
3 wide receivers to the wide side of the field and 1 wide receiver to the short side. That's Gardner to the short side. He's looking that way. Gardner on the hitch. Didn't get it. He is drilled. And drilled hard. Tavarius Tillman, Corey Collins in the vicinity.
Boy, it gets tight. This is where the home team has an advantage. You start getting the crowd behind you, the 12th man. That's an excellent break on the ball.
Clemson has not been effective on third down. They're 2 of 12 third down conversions. 4 wide outs. 10-point deficit they've got to make up. Dantzler doesn't get out of the pile. Gets back to the 21-yard line. Ricardo Wimbush, among others, would not let Woodrow Dantzler advance the football.
Well, Coach O'Leary told Mike Hogwood right before the half, we got to get our defense going. We got to cut down on turnovers, but we got to get our defense playing well. Well, he made those adjustments.
Fourth down and on to punt again as Romano gets a good kick out of there this time. Marvius Hester calls for the fair catch at the 37-yard line. It's a nice boot that time. 41 yards, there's no return. ACC fans, why don't you visit participating JCPenney's locations in your area for your official ACC collection merchandise. Look the part of a great ACC fan, and JCPenney can help. Georgia Tech has the momentum, and they've created it with their defense, stopping Clemson on three straight drives and mounting a long drive of their own. We say long. They had 12 plays and it only took them 4:27, but that's the longest drive of the day.
For this game, you better believe it.
In this game, 4 minutes is an hour.
But you know Clemson eventually, they'll catch on. They'll hit a stride.
And now another timeout taken here as the play clock got all the way down to zero. And that is the second timeout that Georgia Tech has burned here in the third quarter. May come back to haunt them later on.
I'd be real concerned about that. And Ralph Friedgen, I'm sure he is. The bottom line to it is that don't force yourself into a bad play where you lose the ball.
Well, Joe Hamilton has had a very productive day through three quarters. Hamilton has thrown two touchdown passes. This is one of them to Kelly Campbell. A nice fade route that Joe throws better than anybody else. He'll have another one. This is to his tight end, Conrad Andrzejewski. It's two of four touchdown passes he's thrown, and the most recent one. Well, this one goes to Kerry Watkins, his first touchdown reception of the day. And with that touchdown pass, Joe Hamilton is tied with Jamie Barnett for a 59 career touchdown passes. That's an ACC record, and he'll break it with his next one.
These two guys going down to the final gun, if you will, to see who ends up number one.
Jamie Barnett only has one game remaining with East Carolina. Joe will have two more beyond today. They won't be easy ones, though, with Wake Forest, and then, of course, the season finale with Georgia. Wake Forest will be on the road, and Georgia will be back here in Atlanta. So Joe Hamilton's burned two timeouts here in the third. He knows it. He feels he needs another big drive this time. 20 of 27 for the day for Joe Hamilton. Four touchdowns, one interception, 313 yards. First and 10 from the 37. Out of the wishbone. Hand off now. Goes to Dez White. That's his second carry of the day. Not much yardage there.
Now, Terry Jolly was strong on that play.
Number 22, Dez White on the carry.
Let's look at the Yellow Jackets and what they've done this season. They've won five of the last six. Clemson here today. They're at Wake next week. And then home against Georgia on November 27th. And then await their bowl fate. They're already bowl eligible. Here comes Hamilton on his way. First down and more. Carswell wrestles him down at the 43-yard line. That's a 19-yard gain for Joe Hamilton.
Those ribs don't look too bruised following that run, do they, Steven?
No, they don't. He's their leading rusher on the day.
Well, that can help sometimes. That's what halftime's all about. Gives you a chance to mend your wounds. And there, it was a nice physical finish.
Protected those ribs with the football, and Carswell was leaning backwards when he got the hit. First and 10. Hamilton play action. Blitz is on. He gets rid of it. Has a man deep. That was Dez White. Flagged down on the play. Dexter Polite in defense. And this one looks like it's going against Clemson.
Man, it really looked competitive. But you can't, it's going to boil down to contact. And Dexter Polite, my goodness, he's been pressured.
15 yards from the previous spot and a first down.
He's been involved, Steve, in about five deep throws. And we'll look for position. He's beaten. Now, the guy, Des White, is might have been a lot offhand. Might have been his left arm.
Yep.
Maybe pulled a little bit of jersey.
Polite to the sidelines. And Brian Mance is in at that corner. Well, Hamilton having a day. Four TD passes. He's rushed for 78, so he's responsible for close to 400 yards himself. Here's Sean Gregory. And he pulls his way to the 25-yard line. It'll be a gain of about three. Winding down the third quarter. This quarter has belonged to Tech. They've alternated. As you look at Keith Adams, who makes yet another stop. Adams on the day, unofficially at six tackles. He averages 10. Jovan Bush also in on the stop. Three talented sophomores at linebacker, all with 100 tackles or more. Second down, eight. Hamilton running, gets a block on the corner. Turns it upfield and gets to the 21-yard line. He's going to be shy of the first down by about 2 yards.
We've watched Clemson's offense really wear the opponent down in our ball games. And by the fourth quarter, you don't have a lot left. Now you look at the Tiger linemen, and of course, they are sucking in that oxygen. And that's what happens when you deal with the likes of Joe Hamilton.
And they've been out there a lot here in the second half.
Well, they play a lot. I mean, their offense usually doesn't hold on to it long, but they give them points.
They're cranking down time. That'll be it in the third quarter. Joe Hamilton will continue this drive as we start the fourth. Three periods down, one more to go, maybe, from Atlanta. And Georgia Tech leads by 10. Well, Joe Hamilton's got his section. Everybody's got his number. I don't know if they're all from Alvin, South Carolina, but look at the scoring. Clemson in the second. Georgia Tech now taking over the third. And here's a handoff straight ahead for the first down. Sean Gregory gets it, and the drive stays alive down at the 16-yard line of Clemson. Let's take a look at the John Hancock stats through three quarters. The passing yards domed by Georgia Tech, but on the ground, Clemson winning a tight battle there. And the time of possession now, Doc, starting to pile up.
And that's the key. That is the key. They hold on, and you take away those two turnovers that they had, and they would have been way ahead in this ballgame.
Fourth straight third down conversion for the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. Here's the pitch out to the corner to Des White. White hurdles one, and in the end, no, they're going to say he's out. He stepped out at the three-yard line. Des White, 12-yard gain, sets up a first down, could have had a touchdown.
You know he wants some touches. He's had to watch Kerry Campbell have a day. He did bobble that ball, and he bobbled that ball. Might have cost him a chance to turn up field. There's a pitch. Doesn't quite have it. Now he cuts up. Pretty good effort. Has the lead. But let's watch it. Yeah. Yeah. Good call.
Stepped out of bounds at the three. Seventh play of the drive. First and goal. Full house backfield. Three stacked in the eye. Here comes Hamilton to the corner. The pass complete to Wilder. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. The first pass reception of the year, or the first receiving touchdown of the year by Ed Wilder, and he is now alone atop the ACC standings in touchdowns thrown in a career. His fifth of the day and his 60th of his career. Joe Hamilton puts Georgia Tech up. Here's Manjay to add on. He's got it. Flag on the play. Flag on the play. Let's watch the touchdown again.
Hard to deal with Ralph Regan's group, man. So many different options as they put the offensive game plan together with you. You know, freeze option, basic option, dive, lead, sprints, everything.
That time out of a full house, three deep backfield. Penalty against Clemson declined. Point after touchdown is good. And Georgia Tech has added to their lead. They're up 45-28 here in Atlanta. Georgia Tech with 17 unanswered points, leading 45 the 28. Joe Don Reams picking up the kick at the 5-yard line. Right up the middle, he's got lots of room. Reams cuts toward midfield on a nice return out to the 45-yard line for Clemson. The tackle made on the play by Kerry Watkins, but it's a return of 41 yards on the kickoff for Joe Don Reams, who's standing in place of Brian Wofford, who left with a bad knee a couple of moments ago.
Well, that's exactly what this offense needed. They had to, they were the benefactor of good field position. Now you look at Joe Hamilton, numero uno.
Five TD passes and still working. One ahead of Jamie Barnett. Started the day in fourth place, first and 10. Clemson looking to do something other than three downs and out. They've done the last three series. The pass to Sir Gallus is complete near midfield. That's his third catch of the day.
Well, when you want to fix your offense, you go to those rocket scientists that play tight end.
Like yourself.
Those brain guys, brainiacs.
Easy now. They're good people, I'll give you that. Second down and four. The gain of six on the play. Clemson just about a half a foot away from midfield. The shotgun, here's Dan Spurrier, and he is hit from behind, gathers, makes the tackle. He does not get the first down. And let's go to the sidelines of Mike Hogwood.
Well, when they were on the sideline, the defensive coaches told the Tech defense to play with reckless abandon when they're out there. There's more than a two-score lead. They want these young players to play loose, play hard, and they are definitely playing with a lot of emotion right now.
That pass to Sir Gallus, by the way, the first down of the second half for the Clemson Tigers. Making noise, 46,000 strong on third down and three. Dantzler rolls out, pump fake, leaps ahead. He got the first down on second effort if they give him a great spot at the 46-yard line. And it looks like they will. It'll be close. Gunter Kreisen in on the tackle. And it's a first down for Clemson.
Now you call it, Steve-O. Second effort. He fakes the run. And at this point now, this kid just has it. You know, he has that ability to stretch it, to make a play.
Four wideouts now for Woodrow Dantzler, first and 10 at the 46 of Georgia Tech. Down by 17. Play fake, pump and go. He wants Gardner. There's tugging and pulling and pushing. No flags.
Well, he's out of bounds, but he got pulled. That was the difference. He did get held, but he was held out of bounds.
Collins and Tillman in on the coverage. Rod Gardner, here's a look.
Well, these corners, we challenged these corners prior to the game. They had to step up. And that's a terrific effort. And they're out of bounds.
And they have. Tillman, Myers has had a good day. Second down and 10. Ball at the 45. Quarterback draw, big block in the corner, but Dantzler took the outside route and didn't get as much as he probably could have. 5-yard gain, Akil Smith hit on the tackle, gets to the 41-yard line, actually a gain of four.
And this is interesting at the end, I thought it got a little...
That's Gathers, and that's a good one.
Yeah, he is a good one.
True freshman.
Little extracurricular at the end. Focus on the sidelines. Now he's out of bounds at this point. Get the body slam. A better angle here. Take him out. I don't know.
And Gathers was hurt coming from behind.
Yeah.
And the play was over when he got hurt. We'll check on his status.
Well, he's been really productive. He has made big plays when they've needed him.
Third down at six.
They get an extra linebacker. They get an extra defensive back. Shamara Clark is into the ball game now. Third down and six. Ball at the 41. Clemson trailing by 17. Dantzler wants to throw. He does. Complete. Joe Don Reams, who set Clemson up at their own 41-yard line with a great kickoff return, gets a key third down conversion to the 25-yard line of 16 yards.
Woodrow, why don't you just throw this one going backwards? I mean, the guy's going backwards, and he's still able to put a little mustard on it and get it out for a big play.
Good pattern run there by Reams to get into the hole. First and 10. There's Zachary, who's been quiet lately, and Zachary brought down by Chris Young. It's down to the 20-yard line. It'll be a gain of five.
You've got to run it. You can't get away from running the football. Zachary's got to hold a little burden of hope. The burden of having the pressure getting it in between the tackles, but he's got to do it.
Georgia Tech bench exhorting them on. Here comes the pass. It is tipped. And tipped by Wimbush. Ricardo Wimbush with a deflection. Knocked it away. Pass looked like it was intended for Rod Gardner.
Well, you talk about near disaster for the Tigers. Well, you didn't put enough on that. Well, you're right. Wimbush really extended himself. That's a good play.
That was Sir Gallus who was the intended receiver. Third down and four. Another third down facing Clemson. They're 4 for 14. Down by 17 points.
He's a fade route, Stevie. He needs to give these guys a chance in the air.
He's throwing one. He's got one. Mal Lawyer, touchdown, Clemson. Strike Woodrow Dantzler, his second touchdown pass of the day, and the Tigers say we're not done yet.
Well, not with this kind of talent on the edges, but you got to give them deep balls. You got to give them a chance to take the thing vertical.
Third touchdown reception of the year for Mal Lawyer. Here's the kick by Lazara. It is good. Don't go home yet. 45-35, Woodrow Dantzler upstairs to Mal Lawyer for 19 yards and a score, and Clemson's within 10. Georgia Tech 45, Clemson now 35. 11:44 left to go here in the fourth quarter. Steve Martin, Doc Walker, Mike Hodwood coming out of the end zone. Georgia Tech, it's Dez White. White dances his way through a crowd out over the 20 to the 27-yard line. Tackle made on the play by Brian Mance. It's a 27-yard return, and here's the quarterback comparison. Now, keep in mind, Woodrow Dantzler has only been in here for 2.5 quarters. But look at the rush yard. They have combined today, Doc, for 860 total yards of offense.
And counting, 11:33 remaining in the ballgame.
Amazing. Joe Hamilton, first and 10, working from his own 27. The motion is Campbell to the top. The handoff to Sean Gregory, and Chad Carson will bring him down and then get some help from Alex Ardley. Let's go to the sidelines and Mike Hogwood.
Leary, Georgia Leary telling his team right before they went back out on the field on offense, this an important possession. They have to reestablish the momentum of the game, and reminding his offense that this game is a long way from being over. Clemson's offense pretty potent. They need to go and score more points.
They're up 10, and no lead is safe the way that Clemson's been scoring this afternoon. And George O'Leary knows his young defense will give up some points and some yards. Second down and 9. Hamilton to the corner. The pass to Myers is complete. And it's short of the first down. He'll be out to the 35-yard line. The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Jefferson Pilot Sports. This broadcast is a copyright presentation. Any use of this broadcast without the express permission of the Atlantic Coast Conference and Jefferson Pilot Sports is prohibited.
Oh, Myers made a nice catch. He knew he'd get hit because the ball, it turned him inside. He still showed some courage. Good hands.
Joe Hamilton, third down and 2. Georgia Tech has been very successful on third downs. They're 9 of 13. Hamilton, slow developing play. It's intercepted. It's intercepted by Ardley. Ardley brought down by John Carman. But Clemson picks up the ball. This is how they came back in the first half, Doc, with two turnovers. They picked off their third.
Man, oh, Ardley, you talk about step inside and take the game over. I mean, this is a quick drop, rocket throw. Ardley steps in and puts on a play. Now watch this again. He's reading the eyes of the quarterback. Then he breaks, accelerates, takes over. Puts the Tigers in scoring position.
That is the second interception thrown by Hamilton today. It's the 19th picked off by Clemson this year. Tigers first and 10 at the Georgia Tech 31. Here's the pitch. Travis Zachary has some room. Chris Young drives him back after he gets to the 26-yard line. You see Clemson now, Doc, trying to go back to some of the things that they were successful on before Streeter left the game.
Bread and butter, run the ball a little bit, you know, and really try to set them up, I think, for the big one. They got away from throwing the ball downfield.
Second down and five. Out of the shotgun, Dansler. Four wide outs. Here's the end around on the pitch to Reams. Reams has the first down, and he's driven out of bounds by Travaris Tillman at the 17-yard line. And Reams is starting to step up as a central character here in the second half.
Reams is a player. I mean, he gives you great special teams. He gives you that return. He blocks. He's shown good hands. And now you can see him. He's got the little bounce in his step, feeling the game.
He's a redshirt freshman from Seneca, New Jersey. And it'll be first down. Clemson trying to cash in on the turnover. They've gotten a fumble and an interception. They want one more. Here's Gardner on the completed pass to the 13-yard line. Gain on the play of three. Clock rolling along, but not a factor yet. As Clemson's knocking on the door in the red zone.
I think they've kind of settled Brian Wofford out in the offensive mix. You know, it takes a little time for the kids to all get settled. I think they're there.
They had to make one adjustment today to Streeter being out of the game. Here's Dansler on the corner, slips. Gathers is there to help. And also making the tackle is Chris Edwards. And Dansler falls ahead and gets three.
That's good deep. That's very good defense. And especially for a young kid, for a freshman, because that fake could have taken him out. He didn't go with it. He stayed home with his responsibilities.
Well, look what's happening in Winston-Salem, and they're just at the half. 62 points there on our Pizza Hut scoreboard.
Hey, the ACC is on fire.
That game at Durham today. Third down, four. Ball at the 10. Clemson down by 10. Here's Reams in motion. Dansler rolling right. He'll call his own number and get down to the 6-yard line. Right down there on the tackle by Corey Collins. His third stop of the day. And he's close to a first down, Doc. Two quarterbacks at the central theme of this game.
And what have we noticed? But anybody, all of the running backs, QBs, guys aren't messing around now. They're trying to turn it up, hit it.
Dansler, 23 carries, 103 yards. First and goal from the six. Hand off to Zachary. Great tackle made by Jeremy Myers. The true freshman from Stone Mountain, his seventh stop of the day.
I went through coaching changes. Two in college, four in the NFL. Buddy, it's not easy to pick up a new offensive system. Clemson has done a marvelous job.
Second and goal from the five. Here's Dansler. Dansler headed down to the one. And he stopped short of the end zone by Collins and Chris Edwards. But Clemson clearly knocking on the door. 7:22 and counted.
Probably taking more time than they'd like to.
Dansler has been busy. Over the century mark in passing and rushing. Both of these teams rolling up. It's an offense. Eighth play of the drive that started after the interception. Full house backfield. Dansler hands to Zachary. Touchdown Clemson. His third touchdown of the day and seventh in 2 weeks. And the Tigers have cut the margin down to four. Zachary, third score of the day. Here is Romano on the kick. His 14th of the year. Out of the hold of Hamrick. The kick is up, and it is good. Only 3 points separate these two as Zachary scores for the third time today. And Clemson is down 45-42. 6:58 left to go in the fourth. It'll be a case of the last man standing. Georgia Tech's lead of 10, or actually of 17, has evaporated to three as Clemson's come on, cashing in on the third Georgia Tech turnover of the day. They've made them pay for each of the three.
And that's the mark, in my opinion, of a good football team. Change of possession scores, not field goals.
Last three games between these two teams, separated by just 3 points or less. Here's Dez White. Dez White was pulled down once. Meekins got him first. Chad Speck comes up and makes a nice play. And that's his fifth special teams tackle of the day.
This is the hardest hitting ball game I've seen this season.
Hardest hitting, high scoring football game.
This has been the way you, this is old school.
Yeah.
I mean, there's some gadgets in the offense, but buddy, they've been going after it.
Look at the total yards today, nearly 900 between these two. And Georgia Tech's not done. Here's Sean Gregory. Flattened behind the line of scrimmage and pulled down by Keith Adams, among others. And now it is Clemson working with the momentum defensively. Tiger band plays on. I don't know what that call is.
I don't know. I'll tell you what, look at his face. See the intensity.
No Reggie. Second down and 10. Both coordinators working hard this afternoon. There's Hamilton back to throw. Rushes on. Steps up. Steps out. And gets driven. Fumbled the football, but it's blown dead. Keith Adams in there along.
It's just been all over the place. I mean, this guy, he's everything plus some. Now, this took some time. But nobody in his secondary was open. And look the way he closed. I mean, once Keith Adams decided to go after him, man, he closed the cushion.
He wanted to fumble.
That's intensity there.
He wanted to fumble.
You take both these defensive coordinators, we could line these two guys up on the goal line.
May have to. Third and 11. Georgia Tech has not been in this down and distance today. Up by three. Listen to the crowd as Hamilton goes back. And down.
Broderick.
Al Troy Broderick with the sack. Hamilton hits the turf and Georgia Tech was punt.
What a speed rush. Man, he came on an outside. He was chugging.
An intense day on the Clemson sideline. Watch this.
Coming around the corner. Wilder couldn't block it.
Dan Dyke had his last punt blocked. This is only his third of the day. Here comes the kick. Zachary is back to get it. At the 50-yard line, so Clemson will have good field position. Tackle made on the play by Corey Collins. And a flag down. Flag down. Could be personal foul.
Can't lose your composure. You can't win a close game if you lose your composure.
Here's Robin Wood with the call.
Blocking the back of the receiving team. 10-yard penalty from the end of the run in the first down.
Well, could have been worse, but not much. 10 yards back. Push it back to the 41-yard line, but the Tigers have the ball. 4:32 remaining. Remember, Georgia Tech burned two timeouts in the third quarter.
Great point, Steve. Great point.
Eighth penalty of the game against the Tigers for 60 yards. First and 10, Dantzler at the controls. He has four wideouts, five wideouts if you count the wing to the left side. There's the fake to Jodon Reams. Here's the pass to Watts. It is incomplete. Justin Watts trapped the ball. Jamara Clark back in coverage.
Well, Justin didn't sell it either. He didn't try to sell it. Fake it out.
We talked with George O'Leary yesterday about the no-huddle offense and what problems it presents to the defense. You not only can't change personnel groupings, but you don't get your guys back in the huddle. They don't have a time to kind of compare notes, talk to each other. They're just kind of out there alone. Second down and 10. Dantzler changing up. Play clock has 10. High snap, he'll take it. And follows a nice block out front by Akil Smith, the left tackle.
Echol saved it.
Yeah.
He might have popped right out of there.
5-yard gain on the play. You see the clock rolling. Clemson at their own 46-yard line. Big third down coming. There have been many this afternoon. Clemson 7 of 17. They've hit their last five. Here's Dantzler on the corner. Dantzler has the first down and hit hard on the Georgia Tech sideline by Jamara Clark at the 46-yard line of the Yellow Jacket.
Man, got a first down. He also got a helmet. A Rodell right in his chest. How about Gathers' pass rush? I mean, these kids on both sides, they are selling out. Look at that inside pressure. That's super effort. Now watch the hit. Dantzler turns the corner and then power.
Oh, wow. First and 10. Clemson with the ball, 3:46 to play. Down by three. To throw the ball, batted down. Who got it? Wimbush, I think. Ricardo Wimbush batted the ball down.
That might have been picked off. That may have been picked off. That was close. I think Tillman had this in his sights. You see this? Yeah, Wimbush. Boy, talk about an athletic play. Down at the bottom. Woo! Might have been gone.
Dantzler on the corner. Pass is complete. And that's Mal Lawyer struggling out of bounds at the 40-yard line. A gain of six. Jamara Clark with the tackle. Clemson has played error-free football this afternoon.
No, it's just that Mal made a real good job just getting down to get to that football. Want to see some athleticism? Check it out.
Wow. There's Wimbush. And that stayed down.
That stayed down. That's no regard for your body there, pal.
Clemson has made their last six third down conversions after missing on nine of their first 11. Third down and three. Out of the eye. Witherspoon at fullback. There's the pitch. Here's the double pitch in the reverse by Dreams. Going nowhere. Josephson in on the tackle. Josephson snuffed out the play and forces Clemson into a decision.
Man, thank goodness for film study. You can tell the guys who pay attention. It's so tempting to go for fakes and everything. Stayed at home, kept the outside shoulder free, didn't turn it, and allowed his buddies to converge.
And now Clemson is going to call a timeout and talk things over with 3:15 left to play. They've got to make a decision. The ball is at the 43-yard line of Georgia Tech. They're out of field goal range. Should they punt or should they go for first down, keep their drive alive? Will they get the ball back with 3:15 left? Now, Georgia Tech only has one timeout.
Yeah, I mean, Clemson football is aggressiveness on offense. You want to keep putting pressure.
Yep.
That's like a pressing team in hoops. You don't stop pressing. You just keep pressing. That's what you do. You shoot the three, you shoot the three.
Our Texas Pete players of the game, the two signal callers, have had a tremendous day. Woodrow Dantzler in relief of Brandon Streeter, whose career ended with a dislocated hip. 120 yards rushing, 185 yards passing, two TDs. Joe Hamilton, five touchdowns to take the undisputed lead in the ACC in all-time touchdown passes with 60. And let's go to the sidelines for Mike Hogwood.
But I don't think there's any question, Wood Dantzler's coming back out on the field. There wasn't any question that they weren't going to go for it. The timeout, make sure they've got the right play. This a very key play in the ballgame.
Biggest play of the game, fourth and seven. The yard line to get is the 35. They're at the 43. Dantzler rolling left. Pocket rolls with him. Has a long pass planned. A Mal Lawyer knocked out of his hands. Great play made.
That's Young.
Chris Young on defense of Mal Lawyer. And the Tigers give it up on down.
Well, they got it done. They had big plays out on the edge by the corners. But Dantzler might have taken a little bit off the throw. Because it appeared that Mal had some space. And let's watch this. Throwing to your left. Right-handed quarterback throwing to your left. See, he didn't square up. Lawyer was knocked out of bounds. Boy, that's good defensive cornerback work.
Wow, Young on the play. First and 10, Georgia Tech. 3 minutes left to go. Here's the handoff to Gregory, and it's another Georgia Tech first down. Carswell makes his ninth tackle of the day, but it's a 12-yard gain for Sean Gregory.
I believe it.
And a big first down for Tech with three to play.
You can't be demoralized. You're on the defensive unit for the Tigers now. You have to not look at the clock. You got to get the ball back. And the Yellow Jackets let the air out of the tires. That's what you want to do.
There you go. Myers is split wide to one side. Dez White to the other side, and here comes the handoff. It goes to Gregory. Carswell drives him. And he gets down to the 42-yard line.
He was tackled by number 9, Carswell.
Think turnover if you're Tigers. Think securing the football if you're Yellow Jacket. If you had 3 turnovers in this ball game offensively, that never really gets out of your mind as a player.
Second down and 6.
Second and 6.
Reggie Herring exhorting his defensive unit.
Reggie's getting the workout in.
I tell you, Reggie and Ted Roof on the other side, they said this is no week for defensive coordinators.
No week for ego. Both of them have done a good job.
Yep.
It's just who you're going up against.
Second down and 6. Hamilton hands off to Gregory, and we'll see a lot of this here. A big stop here for Clemson at the 40-yard line. Chad Carson makes the stop, his 6th tackle of the day. And we're under 2 minutes to play. Clemson has 2 timeouts remaining. And they're going to take one, I believe, here.
Yeah.
With the prospect of stopping them on 3rd down.
You can't give the Tigers the ball with any clock.
No.
You just can't.
No. Big 3rd down coming here for Georgia Tech. George O'Leary and Ralph Regan talking over the array of options for Joe Hamilton.
Tell you what, Steve-O, there's not a warm remote control in the area. Because every one of them been down for a long time.
Been on the coffee
table. Better believe it.
And it stayed there. And we're not done yet. Minute 51 left to play. We're in the 4th quarter. Georgia Tech 45, Clemson 42, Tech facing a 3rd and 3. And our Amico play of the game. It's the 4th down hold and the play by Chris Young. You saw it a few moments ago. Woody Dantzler looking at a 4th down and 7. Rolled out with protection. Went for the end zone for Mal Lawyer. But Young is there to make the deflection and deny Clemson not only a 1st down, but possibly a touchdown. That would have put them ahead in the game. 3rd and 3. Here we go. Strap it on again.
Can you have 2 Amico plays of the game? Because you might have one here.
You have to redo it. 3rd down and 3. Here is Hamilton. Hamilton, a sure bet for the 1st down and more.
Oh, and he stayed in. Look at the kid's IQ. That's the football IQ there, folks. That's thinking about getting the job done from the neck up.
Now, they stop the clock to move the chains, but once they're reset, the clock will roll again. 1st down. Georgia Tech at the Clemson 26-yard line. Joe Hamilton.
Boy, just a treat. We're lucky.
I'm very lucky to be able to witness this young man over the last 4 years. And there's 2 more games left. Wait for us next week and the season ender with Georgia plus a bowl date. Here comes the handoff, goes to Gregory, and Gregory is inside the 25. Clemson can stop the clock one more time, and they have done it. They've used their final timeout with 75 seconds left to go. And now it's time to look at the BMW Ultimate Drive of the Game. It's brought to you by BMW, the ultimate driving machine. We look at Georgia Tech early in the 4th quarter. They are driven downfield, and on their 45th point, it's a pass to Ed Wilder. 7 plays, 63 yards, 2 minutes and 52 seconds to do it. Wilder's 1st touchdown catch of the season, and the 5th touchdown pass thrown by Joe Hamilton. That's our BMW Ultimate Drive of the Game. And it resulted in the 45th point going on the board. Travis Zachary would like one more chance. But right now, it's up to the defense. And let's look at Doc's analysis now. Doc, you made some critical points at the beginning of this ballgame that would have been spelled success. Tillman and Clark had to win on the edge. Clemson's held to 104 yards.
Yep, that one worked. Talked about success between the tackles. And I think Zach's done pretty good as well as both backs. And then the Hamilton factor, well, I mean, that's pretty tough to deal with.
Yeah.
But yet they've still been in a position to win. So JP and the boys have done a great job on that one. I think that analysis proved out to
Excellent job by our graphics people, Jeff Paris and Jill McDivitt.
JP, he's a freak of nature. How can one guy be so talented?
Good question. Second down and eight. Here's Gregory. He's hit initially by Jolly and cleaned up by a host. Now, Clemson cannot stop the clock again. 1:07 left to go. They've used their last timeout. It's a third down coming here, but don't expect Georgia Tech to hurry and huddle up.
Oh, no.
Probably
you would give up some real estate on this one.
Yep, probably accept a delay of game here and then just take a knee. 52 seconds and counting. Joe Hamilton has been the man today. He's had some turnovers, thrown two interceptions, but he's had another banner day of total offense at a 500 plus. Third down and eight. Georgia Tech's got to get the first. Here comes Gregory. He's got the first and more.
Nice step out.
Driven out of bounds at the three-yard line. 21-yard gain on the play will set Georgia Tech up first and goal with 30 seconds left to go at the three-yard line.
When you can run it, you can always control it. And that's the key. Nice block on the edge of Kay Williams. And right there, boy, that's just solid, hard-nosed football.
The Yellow Jackets knew they had to run one more play. And now here they go on first and goal. Joe Hamilton wanting to put this one way out of the reach of the Clemson Tigers, although it probably already is, provided they don't turn it over. Here's the handoff. Gregory fighting his way down to the one. He was driven into the end zone but stopped just shy of it. And it is going to be second and goal. Clock runs down. There'll not be another play. This one finally ends here at Georgia Tech, and the Yellow Jackets spring to the win. Tommy Bowden knows his team gave it a turn this afternoon. They got to within three, but couldn't seal the deal. Georgia Tech prevails by three, 45-42.